What's up, everyone, and welcome to the Monday Night Wolfcast, the special megacast E3 post-free episode for June 13th. I almost screwed that up. This is episode 6. My name is Wolfie, and today I'm joined by my friends, Sinist.
Hello.
And Zeromus3.
Hello!
But I'm going to go straight into what I did this week, since mine is going to be really short. I only got to play a tiny little bit of Dark Souls 3 this week with Ubert. Just a little bit. No progress was made, so, yeah. It's still being worked on. Oh, right, and the week before that, actually, I did do something. I got to see Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. Scoots, did you get to see that?
Nope, I did not.
Okay, so I'll just go over real quickly my thoughts about that movie, in case you guys are curious. I know you are, Bert. You're riveted.
Always.
Yeah. So, the game was better. There you go.
Oh. That's another thing you did. You played that game.
Oh, yeah, we did play it. Well, I mean, the parts...
directly after the last podcast.
Yeah, the parts are still going... There's one more part that's going up. It's a three-parter. But, yeah, the movie... it was good. It wasn't the trailers were made it a lot more fun than it really was.
I like, heard it was trash.
I can see those opinions and why they would say that, but to be fair, Ninja Turtles movies, barring the first original two and the animated ones, are trash. The first one is trash, but I like that. But this one is like, if you grew up with Ninja Turtles and you, say, have an attachment to Bebop Rocksteady, Casey Jones, Baxter Stockman, Krang, you will have a smile on your face when they show up, but that smile will quickly fade when you realize they didn't do them good. The only characters they really did right were Bebop and Rocksteady. Like, those were the best characters in that movie. Like, it was really fun to watch those two. Because they were just fucking stupid, and like every time they showed up, it just brought a smile to my face. They were really, 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 really into the characters. You could tell. I kind of want to do a spoiler because it kind of ties into why I didn't care for the others, but I'll probably save it just for a little bit at the end. But Casey Jones was a wasted character. Absolutely nothing was done with him. He wasn't even Casey Jones. It was just whoever played him showed up, was wearing the mask for like 2 minutes for one fight scene, and after that, he's no longer Casey Jones. He takes the mask off, he's just a regular guy that helps out with Megan Fox, and who's supposed to be April O'Neil, and I still don't like I still don't like Megan Fox as April O'Neil. It doesn't work well with me. The Turtles were great. You can't really screw them up. Shredder, I will talk about that during spoilers. Krang, iffy. On a whole, I will say I think I enjoyed the first movie as a whole more, but the second one had more things in it that I liked. But the movie in general was just not great. So that was Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows for me, just a brief summary. And I don't think I did anything else this week. So I will pass the torch over to you, Scoots. What did you do these last few weeks?
I sat there, besides working, playing Pokemon Yellow and Legend of Zelda, or not Legend of Zelda, I mean Hyrule Warriors Legends. I beat Hyrule Warriors Legends and Pokemon Yellow. I'm at the Elite Four. Getting ready for that Sun and Moon, basically.
You're getting your Pokemon bank ready?
Yes, I am getting that all ready.
Oh, I can't wait to talk about that later on in this podcast.
Like, did they add the Pokemon bank to those already?
No, not yet.
Oh, it still hasn't rolled that out?
They'll probably release that when it gets really close to Sun and Moon.
It'd be for the best, really.
But besides all of that, I also had an awesome battle against scalpers.
Oh no, did you finally bite the bullet?
I'll have to tell you the whole story.
Go on, I'm ready. Actually,
I went to a micro center around where I live, and that place is amazing. That's like Christmas to all of us, but whatever. It's like the PC part, PC building store. I go up to the at the PC building area, right?
Mm-hmm.
Before I actually talked to the guy, there was two guys talking about they're going to get GTX 1080s. If no one knows what that is, that's the highest-end NVIDIA card at the moment that just came out 2 weeks ago. Am I right, Bert? I know I'm right.
As of this date, yeah.
Probably.
Yeah, it was May 27th, I believe, was when it was released. But these two people in front of me, they were talking about how they were going to scalp the graphics card, right? That's all I kept talking about. And this guy that was at the, you know, at the desk, he hears all of this. And then he's just standing there smiling. And then they ask if they could get a, like, two GTX 1080s. First thing the guy says, "We don't have any in stock. Sorry." And then the two guys are like, "Oh, man." And they walk away, right? Then I go up to this guy, and I'm all like, "Excuse me, do you have any GTX 1080s? So I've been looking for like 2 weeks. I haven't been able to find one, and people have been price gouging the crap out of these things. Hence the battle of scalpers I've been going through." Then the guy's like, "Oh, sir, we have plenty of them in the back." So he gets me one, right? As he gets me one, those two guys, they were still lingering. They saw this, right? As I got it.
Yeah.
I turn around, and I'm like, "What? What?" Then I walk away.
So the moral of the story is, if you're going to scalp, don't fucking say your evil plan next to the person you're going to try to scalp it.
Exactly.
Like, if you're going to be an evil, evil villain, and you're tying up the maiden to the railroad tracks, don't twiddle your mustache while you're doing it in front of the sheriff. Do that shit away from them where they can't see. Then you'll get away with it.
Especially idiots. If you're trying to charge like $2,000 for something.
I am curious though, how much is the, like, what's the normal price of this graphics card, and like, what's the scalper price going for right now?
$700, and the scalper price, it starts from $800 and it goes all the way up to
$2,000. Oh.
But what I've been told is if you buy it at, let's say, $800, right? A lot of the sellers will try to cancel it and charge more.
Looks like they're 900 plus on eBay right now.
Jesus.
Okay. Yeah, so prices just keep jumping.
I got it for its right retail price, so I was happy about that.
Everything will eventually even itself out once, what's it called? Supply picks up.
Yeah, once they get more stock.
Yeah. But, you know, everything happens like that when it's something brand new and people really, really want it.
Especially these versions of the GTX 1080s, the Founders Edition. It's not really anything special with it. It's just, hey, you can have a day one edition.
Yeah, it's like first edition stuff.
Oh. Yeah, I thought it was going to be because of the World of Warship 15-day premium thing included in there.
I also got XSplit.
Did it come with that?
Oh, did it?
It's on the back of the box. Let me get this
a
box.
A paid version, or is it just like a time
probably
period?
Probably like a month.
Okay.
Or like a year, maybe, if they're very generous, but I doubt it.
Well, why would you get XSplit when OBS does everything it does for free?
It's a one-year premium license.
Oh, shit. That's not so bad.
You better start doing some hardcore streaming whenever you activate that thing.
It comes with GPU tweak 2 times XSplit Gamecaster.
I wonder how much a year of XSplit even is.
Dude, I don't know, like $50?
Probably not too expensive, yeah.
It says tweak till your heart's content with intuitive new UI. GPU tweak 2 makes overclocking easier than ever. And it says game booster to maximize graphics performance. And of course, XSplit to stream your gameplay as I'm throwing this box behind me. That's all.
So how about you, Bert? What was your last week like?
Well, Scoots also played Guilty Gear, right? The story mode?
Oh, yeah. I did. It's like watching an anime movie.
Yeah, I guess there's really not too much to talk about that.
No. I mean, he could talk about it, but I still have yet to play it, and I mean, I'm not really going in crazy, like, don't spoil it for me, but at the same time, I'm like, if I'm gonna watch it, I kind of want to know, you know, I kind of don't want to know. So, did you want to talk about the story at all? Like, at least, like, your impressions of it? The Guilty Gear story?
It explains a lot.
And this is Relevator, not Sign. Just to clarify that, because that just came out.
But basically, it ties in a lot of things. Things that we already knew about, like Dizzy, mm-hmm. her origins, we already know about that, right? I would hope you mm-hmm. know.
Yeah. She's the most important character in the game. I do have a question, though.
She only had, like, one scene in the game story. Good luck finding that.
Oh. Does, like, say, other Guilty Gear characters that aren't playable right now besides Baikin show up?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you need to know?
I was curious.
Or do you want to leave that spoiler free?
I'll just leave it spoiler free for now. Okay. It's probably not anything impressive. I want to have that moment if they show up and it's a hype moment, like, oh shit, there they are.
It isn't, but at the same time, no. I am still questioning why Potemkin's leader is still mm-hmm. not a playable character. That character is too awesome.
Because
he did something in the story mode that was amazing.
He did something amazing in the last story mode that was amazing.
That made Superman look like a weakling.
I believe that. Oh, sorry, Vert, that was actually supposed to be part of your week, but you reverted it back to Scoots. Would you like to actually take the ball in your court this time and say what your week was like?
Well, last week I finished Uncharted 4.
Oh, how was it?
I liked it, even without, you know, having any context from the other ones. And I think it ended well. Obviously, I won't go into that too much, but...
Yeah, don't worry.
Even not knowing what happened, it's still pretty it's okay. good self-contained.
I know what you're talking about, Bert.
Did you see that Kotaku article?
Which one? You mean the glitch one?
No, I was talking about the ending. They do a pretty good write-up if anyone's interested.
Yeah. I've seen the ending, actually. But we're not going to talk about that.
Yeah, it's a pretty good way. And I think they're finally maybe wrapping up that series. Which
there's going to be more. You know there will be.
Maybe. They still have more Last of Us if they want to.
Right.
I mean, they still have other IPs anyway. But they do have their... They leave it open a bit so they could keep going if they wanted. Other than that, I finished Mirror's Edge Catalyst.
Oh. Now, you've been really looking forward to this one, so I'm rubbing my fingers together really greedily like a fly over shit right now, so let me know. How was it, Vert?
Well...
Mm-hmm.
I liked it a lot.
Of course you did.
A lot of critics are not really too fond of it, though.
Why?
I think people are hung up on, like, story stuff, which I don't really care about, I guess. I just think the gameplay is really great. Same stuff from the first one. And the story mode in the first one was pretty bad anyway, so it's not like I had huge expectations going into this one.
So let me ask you one thing. What did you not like from it?
The loading for the console version. I played it on PS4 because there's a lot of times when you need to retry a challenge and sometimes those load times could just be longer than actually doing the challenge. So, you know, like in something like Meat Boy, you just instantly retry.
Oh yeah.
It makes the difficulty fine that way.
Mm-hmm.
Like if something's hard in that and you have to retry, it just takes up so much time.
Okay. I get what you, that was the perfect thing you could have said right there, because as soon as you said Super Meat Boy, how it just loads instantly, I was like, I got what he means.
That's why I used that example. But yeah, like, just I love the control method for those games. Like, coming from Uncharted, where you just point the analog stick in a direction and just jam on X to go wherever you want. Like, having multiple button presses just to, like, do anything is just a lot of fun. It's very mechanical, like gameplay-ish. I don't know. I really liked it.
Okay.
But I really liked the first one also, so there's that.
I was going to say, which one do you like more, the first one or this one?
I think the first one had better... Like, this one's an open world, I guess I should say that. So sometimes, like, the levels aren't, like, handcrafted so much, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
It's the problem I had with, like, Burnout Paradise. They didn't have levels, like, real stages. It was just an open world, and some of the tracks could be good, depending on what routes you took, stuff like that. So I think, okay. Like, design-wise, like, the routes you run are probably better in the first one. I think there's some pretty good moments in 2 also. Or Catalyst, I guess they're not calling it 2. But it's also been quite a while since I played the first one. It maybe doesn't hold up, I don't know.
Okay, let me ask you one thing. Is Catalyst basically a retelling of 1?
Yeah, it's like an origin story, but also like a reboot at the same time.
So like the new Tomb Raider was for...
Yeah.
Okay.
There's some of the same characters and stuff, but like just different.
How do you guys feel about that? Like, reboots that do that? Just, it's a reboot, and also at the same time a retelling of, like, kind of like what the Star Fox Zero was, too, if you think about it.
Yeah.
I guess it depends on where they were at in the story. Like, if it's something you wanted it to continue, or if it was just, like, it went a bad direction, kind of like MK. Like, no one liked where it was going, so they rebooted it, and I guess everyone likes it now.
I like how they rebooted it too. Everyone died. Now let's restart the universe.
Like, I can't think of any examples where they rebooted something like that, a story that you want.
They do it all the time in Marvel and DC.
Yeah, but that's comics. Talking game wise, you couldn't think of one. I was about to say Sonic Boom, but I was like, that's not really a story game. It's hardly a game.
It might count. Like, something like SSX, the new one, like, the tone of it went the wrong way. But, like, there's no story that you have to worry about in that, really.
Really, any game that takes the title of said game and just has that title again, like, say, Doom, or Sonic the Hedgehog, or Tomb Raider. It's just the first title of the first game, just the title.
Yeah, it's been a trend lately.
I guess. Like, Ratchet and Clank. There you go. That's another one that's recent.
Well, yeah, but that was kind of a retelling of the first game.
Exactly. That's a reboot retelling. Or was it actually just a retelling?
I think it was almost the exact same.
Oh,
obviously
just updated.
I mean, I don't know 100%, but...
None of us are Ratchet and Clank enough. Okay. Sorry to take that off subject, but yeah... So was there anything else you did this week? Or last week, Bert?
Not that I can think of. I think that's about it.
Awesome. Well, if that's said, guys, let's go ahead and just get straight into the gaming news. So as we said before, this is taking place the day of... E3. So as we're doing this podcast, news is breaking as we're talking. So this docket, as we're reading over it, is literally being updated.
This day is over.
Yeah.
But so we're not going to have anything for actual Monday. Like the 13th. Like, we're not going to have anything about Microsoft or Sony or any of that.
But we not do by the have, time this goes up.
Yeah, because we're recording it before that happens.
We can always do a reaction for that, though.
We could, but work and conflicting schedules. I mean, you guys could do it, and we could all do it and just compile into it. We'll figure something out. But basically, our disclaimer is, yeah, this is all pretty much going to be day before E3, so a lot of this is going to be speculation and predictions. We're all pretty much going to, you know... Next time we do this podcast, it's going to be like, oh man, were we wrong or were we right? Wow.
Well, with how much stuff has leaked, I think we'll be fine.
Pretty much the whole E3 press conference at this point has been leaked, but here we go. Let's just say we get into this. Day one was EA and Bethesda.
Are we gonna go for that, or are we gonna go for like the weeks before? Because we have all this other stuff. So.
Oh, you're right. Okay,
we can do the press conferences first, or we can do everything that happened before that.
No, we need to hit the old news first and get updated from like the previous weeks, and then get caught up, and then get into the E3 stuff. All right, so going in order. The Xbox One price officially reduced to $299. Potentially limited time only, you know, yada, yada, yada.
They always do that every E3, though.
Yeah, well, it looked like it was going to be, like, that was just the official price. And then they came out and said, oh, it's limited till June 13th, which is when Microsoft's press conference is. Hmm. And the Xbox One S leaked, which is the smaller version, like a slim version. It's supposed to be 40% smaller and has a 2 terabyte hard drive. So again, I'm going to guess it's going to be that version, and I guess all of them will be 300 permanently.
You think so?
Unless they want to make the S 350 and have the other ones just stay at 300 to get rid of stock.
That is true. And then I'm thinking also with the new Xbox coming out, not the new one, but you know, the updated version.
Scorpion or Scorpio.
Yeah, the Scorpio or whatever it's called, lingering around the corner. They might also want to potentially get rid of whatever units are out there. Not that they're lingering or whatever, but...
Oh, I think they're going to keep... Well, they want to get rid of the old ones and probably keep the S's around.
Yeah, that's
they're,
what I mean.
I think that was the plan.
Yeah.
In general. They said get they were going to have the old models, and they were going to have the new one.
Yeah, I'm S guessing model since and the S has a 2 terabyte, it's going to be 350. And they're going to keep the old ones at 300 maybe to get rid of stock.
The crazy thing is, most of those terabytes will be used to update on the first update you get when you turn on your system. Ain't that right, Scoots?
The updates aren't that big.
Hey, Sinist.
What's up?
It's okay. When I get that Project Scorpio Xbox One, you'll totally be rocking an Xbox One as well.
Oh, but I wanted one. He doesn't want it. I want Dragonborn.
I can do that really well.
Well, come on over. Don't you have the Kinect? Because I don't think the S is going to have a... Well, it might have a port for it. Who knows? Well, I guess we'll know tomorrow.
I only accept this if you two...
I don't want the S. I want the Project Scorpio one.
Oh, yes, right. That's what I was thinking.
Why would he get an S if he can get a Scorpio?
I forget. Yes. What's well, there's so many consoles coming out. Who knows what it's called anymore?
They're all just... At this point, they're all running together. But that they're going to be cheap.
Did you know that Cortana... is going to Xbox One?
It sure is. Which is interesting since they're reportedly not going to have Kinects in them, so they might have to have voice recognition through, like, mics.
You mean like the PlayStation 4?
Yeah, because I don't think you could do that with the Xbox One, right? You have to use the Kinect to use voice.
I never really played around with it. I think you can use your voice.
Yeah, with Kinect, but I don't think you can use the mic.
I mean, with the actual mic, I think you can.
Maybe.
I'll have to play around with it.
Oh.
I always use the Kinect, so.
You're like one right of the now, few, Scoots.
Right now, I could be all like, Xbox on! Oh my god, I win!
There you go.
Xbox.
Yeah.
Xbox is like, why? Why did you turn me on? Why?
The time to game?
I hope so. I really hate being turned on for no reason.
I mean, Overwatch is in it, and I still haven't played it, and it pisses me off.
Oh, shit. That should have been part of your week. Speaking of part of the week, move on to the next news story. I don't know how to say this. Onechanbara Z2 Chaos and Senran Kagura Shinovi versus...
The whole reason I put these on here is to have you say them.
Are you... Wait. Okay, seriously? Wait, was that the whole title, or was that just like a run-on sentence?
Those are two games.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay, I see. Oh, it's Onechanbara Z2 Chaos was one game, and Senran Kagura Shinovi Versus. What the fuck titles are these? Are going to be out on Steam?
Like, they are on Steam now.
Oh, they're on Steam. Well, then.
So let me ask you, Bert, which one would you play?
I've already played Onechanbara, but I played the PS4 version. But apparently it's not a great port. It has mixed reviews on Steam anyway. But I'd probably play Senran Kagura just because I haven't played it yet.
And yes!
Is that the only reason you would play it, Bert?
Well, whatever. People seem to really love that game on Steam. Like, it's gotten really good reviews.
Is the port good?
I'm guessing so. People wouldn't love it otherwise, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's at 95%, which is overwhelmingly positive.
I bet you a lot of those people who rated that thing up have probably prom night issues.
It's just, I figured it was worth mentioning since we always talk about games that are censored. Like, here's some games that aren't afraid to be what they are.
You know, I'll give credit to Senran Kagura, because those games know what they are and they're just like, fuck it. This is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
No point hiding it. Do you like this? Does this look like something you'd enjoy?
It's like, you see this weeboos? Come at me.
Jump into this ample bosom. Do it. Nerds.
Freaking weeboos. I love you guys.
We love you all. Please jump into our ample bosoms. I mean, Vert was the... I can't say this. Onechanbara Z2 Chaos.
Uh-huh.
Isn't that the one where there's like two cowboy chicks and two ninja? Yeah, I've seen this like in PS4. Like, I've seen this box all over the damn place. No one buys this game. What is it?
It's just like a game kind of like Bayonetta and stuff like that. But obviously not as good.
No!
Like those style of games.
Beat 'em ups.
Slash 'em ups.
Yeah, okay.
Whatever genre you want to call it.
Whatever you want to call it. I was going to say, because when you compare it to Bayonetta, I just...
I mean, it's not as good as that. So.
He was freaking out. And he was like, no!
I just don't know what the genre is called.
My body rejected that answer. Couldn't handle it. You know what I can't handle?
What's that?
The next news story. Well, actually, I can't handle it. Ibuki was delayed. Street Fighter V was the story mode. Till the end of this month, June. As well as a couple other issues that Capcom brought up, you know, about Street Fighter V and you know, kind of what to expect with the June story update. And the June story update is huge. There's a lot of stuff we got to cover in this. So, starting with Ibuki. How did you guys feel about Ibuki? Just not the delay, but the actual character.
Throwing bombs.
Yeah, she seems cool. She's like Sector from MK.
I see that, actually. I actually see that.
That's apparently her V-trigger.
The thing that throws me off about her is kind of her outfit.
I think it looks good.
I'm mixed on it. I don't really...
You want the classic ninja outfit.
Not even that, really, because I can understand, you know, the story mode and everything. They can't really have her being in that outfit just yet, but at the same time, I don't know. I guess it's all right when it's put that way, but I don't know. Expecting a little something more? Don't even get me started on that DLC outfit for her.
That one's bad. I'll agree with you on that.
the Karen, what was it? The Karen alt? They just repurposed?
Put like a purse around her waist.
They DOA'd that costume, really. They were just like, here's the summer dress outfit.
Just change the color, it works.
Also kind of bad that DOA outfits are cheaper than Street Fighter outfits.
Yeah.
They don't have quite so many where they have $99 season passes.
I was about to say, but Bert, does Street Fighter V have $99 season passes? Multiple $99 season passes.
You find an outfit you like, you pay $2 to $3.
I'm waiting for the Sensor Bar DLC. For DOA.
Can they go that far?
They already have, basically.
Yeah.
I mean, they're one good outfit away from just being nude mods.
Yeah, it's the whole point.
$1,000 season pass for the nude mod per character.
Buy the PC version.
Yeah, take out a second lease to get this outfit.
Well, yeah, I can play the PC version now. GTX 1080.
Yeah.
No problem. Besides that, recommend it.
No. No. Besides that, there's a couple of other things that were brought up as far as the updates on Street Fighter V are concerned and why, you know, everything's kind of been really late.
Mm-hmm.
There's been, apparently, Capcom has been in the same situation as a couple other companies, namely my favorite company, Sega, with their Japanese and US branches just kind of doing their own thing. the U.S. branch promising things that the Japanese branch was like, what the fuck? We didn't. Did you okay this? No? U.S. Capcom USA, what are you doing? Why are you releasing these flowchart plans of future potential deals? We did not agree to these dates.
Apparently, so, I didn't know this, but Capcom USA is the ones who own Street Fighter, the brand.
I knew that.
So they kind of call the shots, and then I guess Japan just didn't realize or something. I don't know.
It's some weird stuff going on here. Like, so basically, Capcom has just come out and said, "No, we fucked up. We're gonna try to be more open about our DLC plans. You know, make it better for you." For some reason, they sound like, I don't know, some defeated sheriff from the south. But there's a lot else as well to include this June story update, which I think had probably the best things announced in there, such as there's not going to be a Zenny system. The Zenny system is gone. Oh, it's going to be just pure money. Just no converting. Just straight up U.S. and or other currencies that you use to buy the costumes, outfits, stages, characters, whatever have you. That's the thing they established. As well as the story mode being, you are able in the story mode to play as all the DLC characters. Which to me, makes me very, very happy. So you get to try them free, basically. And I'm like, yes. This is a way to have you play the characters and see if you like them. I don't have to take a gamble and be like, well, what if I don't like them? So I get to try them all. And you get to try them before they get released, too, if you really think about it, Bert. So you actually get to try Jury before she comes out.
Long you get to try Balrog and Yurian.
I do.
Same with Scoots.
And Yurian. Yurian. Oh, he looks so...
He better barrier burst his clothes, I'm telling you.
He better rip that shit off.
It's not Yurian.
His art in that picture actually looked pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course you would say that.
Do you want to know it doesn't look face. Good?
He know, always has that fucking good? Face though, that really intense like kill face. Like Yurian's gotta have that face at all points in time. I'm
then
okay with this.
The Balrog face that looks so.
Oh God!
It's like they boxed him. It's a box face.
I don't understand why they can't just draw black people without having the fucking lips. Like, why do they got to do that every fucking time? It's like the center focal point of Balrog's character design. Well, his lips are huge. They're massive. They ain't natural.
When you punch a guy so many times in the face,
Capcom knows what they're doing. They do this every time. Oh well, I'm sure Bert. I'm sure you're gonna say in that same picture for the story they showed that you're gonna be, oh, Jury looks great though.
I mean, she's kind of faded out in the back. So who knows?
You see enough of her stupid smiley. I'm gonna get you, face.
I hope they explain that Bison ripped her eye out just so I could laugh. Yeah, I went there, Bert. Yeah.
I hope Bison went further. I hope he, like, took all her limbs off and she's just like a fucking...
She's not Cody.
I'm just doing it to spite you, Bert. I don't like Jury.
That's fine. You don't have to. Mm-hmm.
No, I do.
I don't like Balrog.
Yeah, but you like Yurian. And we all like that banana hammock he's got. He should be sporting it. Do it, Capcom. Show you have some balls by showing his balls. Do it. God damn it. I can't wait for Yurian, though. It's going to be hype. Balrog, I'm mixed because, they've been talking about the character. He lost his headbutt. Sad day for Balrog fans like me. But I'll deal, I guess.
He'll probably have something new.
I mean, they're all going to have something new, probably.
Exactly. That's...
That's pretty much all there is to say on Street Fighter V. Unless there's anything else you guys want to talk about. Bert, you want to talk about Jury anymore?
We don't even know anything.
Make something up. All right. Scoots, I'm sorry, this next news story. This next one is for you.
I'm so disappointed.
I'm so happy about this.
Well, I'm so disappointed we don't have these in the U.S. I want one.
Okay.
You can't see my face right now.
We can feel it.
Pachinko machine.
You
right
know what?
Right next to me. I want to play it. Just play the pachinko. I don't even care.
Speaking of pachinko machines, this is a direct tie-in. New Metal Gear Solid game announced autumn 2016. It's going to follow the best Metal Gear Solid game, of course, the one with the best theme. Snake Eater! Sadly, it's pachinko, though. So, there's that.
Okay, let me tell you one thing. Every time when I see someone playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Right here, right now. Every time I see someone play Yu-Gi-Oh! Or have any form of Konami thing in front of me, I am reminded of pachinko machines and how we don't have pachinko machines.
I like
how why don't we have that?
I like how you're getting upset that we don't have pachinko machines and not the fact that what they're doing to Metal Gear.
He doesn't care. He wants to. As long as he can play it, it's fine. But he can't play it, so he's not.
I'm getting there too, and the fact that they combine Metal Gear with my love of pachinko machines.
I think they'll have a ladder climbing segment in that.
Pull the lever!
Pull the lever!
It's just a long ladder. Oh my god. I'm legitimately just at this point, there's literally nothing more that can be said other than fuck Konami. Like, can't they pull the lever? Fuck Konami. What can we say? I am in legit shock, and it looked to me, I could be wrong, I haven't played Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater, but it looked to me like it was all updated using the new Metal Gear engine they had.
For sure.
So there could have been something great there.
It's Konami, though. They don't like us.
They don't like anybody.
So good.
The trailer they released for that, I believe, is one of the most disliked on YouTube right now. It hasn't hit Call of Duty Infinite Warfare levels yet.
Do you want to know why they dislike it? Because we don't get pachinko machines in the U.S.
I think there's another reason to that.
You know, there's a great demand for pachinko machines in the U.S.
There's a huge, and Konami's not filling it.
Let me ask you one thing. Would you, the consumer, be willing to play a pachinko machine?
Me personally?
Yeah. I know you would.
It depends on what the pachinko machine is.
Like Bert here. He has an undying love of pachinko machine. He wants
we
one
can't
so
get him
bad.
To stop talking about
he
it.
He wants to be called pachinko Bert.
Pachinko Bert?
I might have to use that.
He's so disappointed. Bert. This guy is so disappointed that he can't get his pachinko machine, so he's all like, I guess I'm gonna have to retire pachinko Bert. He looks down on the ground.
You can't do a video on it because you can't play it. Oh,
it's
my
okay.
God.
You have some weird form of it in PSO 2, I think.
Of course. I don't know. There's not even a pachinko in PSO 2. It's just Blackjack
It's close enough. It's the rappy slots, but it's like really close to pachinko. Like, borderline close.
Just needs to have something there. I mean, that's pretty much all there is to say on that. Guess
we'll
we can all just say fuck Konami. So, there we go. Next news story.
Hashtag fuck Konami 2016. Hashtag. Just go to the next thing.
Rumor. Nintendo NX production delay till 2017 to add VR support. Okay.
Sounds about right.
Yeah.
VR support? I could do that right now.
Oh,
it was on the box.
Another interesting thing is they halved how many units they were getting produced. They're expecting sales to be half of what they were actually expecting.
Really?
Yeah, because they think the console market is shrinking, which I guess is somewhat.
There's always going to be a demand for console gaming.
And since the Wii U did so bad, they kind of doing less consoles, so it might be a Wii situation.
Oh god.
We don't know this yet until they actually start releasing those consoles with those updates.
What do you mean?
Yeah. Are you talking about the Neo and the Scorpio?
Yeah. I call it PlayStation 4.5.
That's a whole different thing, since those are still like the same hard, or they still run the same games.
It is, but
and this is a whole new thing.
If you're thinking about like consumer wise, they're probably going to be all like, "What the hell? Why?"
I think Nintendo just lost a lot of faith, and consumers lost a lot of faith in Nintendo because of the whole Wii U debacle. Like, to there's still to this day, people who don't know what the hell a Wii U is. The consumers, the general populace does not know what a Wii U is. Nintendo fucked up. That's how they failed at advertising and getting, you know, educating the consumer on what this product is. People still think, when they ask me, like, is that gamepad there, the device? No, it's the system behind it. What's that? That's the actual system. And it's a mess, so I could kind of see why they're a little unconfident, but they need to go into this next one strong. They need to break that shit in like they did with the Wii. Make it a runaway success if they can.
Maybe they can do that with VR.
And they need to promise what they say they're going to put on there, like GameCube support.
Still waiting on that eShop shit, Nintendo.
Yeah, where the hell's my GameCube games, Nintendo? Where's
my Game Boy Advance games, Nintendo?
You mean on your 3DS, right?
No.
Oh.
What a mess.
Because I have those Game Boy Advance games on my 3DS.
Oh, of course you do.
Ambassador program, but at the same time, it makes you wonder, why have they not released that?
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Ambassadors feel special.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like Nintendo. 2 years.
Nintendo 2 years hates money.
That's true.
They really do. But you know what's going to get my money?
Wonderboy?
Wonderboy the Dragon's Trap is getting a remake. Dude, this is sick. Like, it's one of my favorite Sega Master System games ever. So for those that don't know, Wonderboy, a.k.a. What's it called in Japan? It's Wonderboy. Is it Dragon's Trap or Dragon's Curse? Either way, it's Wonder Boy 3, Dragon's Trap, is getting this sick HD remake, courtesy of, I forgot who was behind it, but it looks amazing. If you've ever seen anything related to this game at all, like the original, and you look at this HD remake side by side, they put the work in. I'm surprised this wasn't kickstarted. This is really amazing, and I'm super happy that it's like, it's one of my favorite games, and I get to see it updated. Bert, did you see it?
Yeah.
What'd you think? Yeah, I know you have no connection to it. You gotta admit, the visuals and everything look good on it.
Looks like a Flash game.
When you say a Flash game, that gives negative connotations. It looks great, and
this is the kind of graphics that usually you say looks awful.
No, Bert.
Like, no, it has to be pixelated.
What have I ever said anything has to be pixelated?
You hate the way like stuff like Skullgirls looks.
I never said what
you have.
What the fuck, dude?
You said that.
I have
you
never
prefer stuff like Blaze Blue.
What the fuck? What is wrong with you? What are you guys coming off of?
I've never said that.
I've never once said that.
You have said this before.
I've never said that. I love the way Skullgirls looks. I don't believe you guys are going to try to make me look like a villain here.
You say you don't like those like hand-drawn stuff. You like this pixel?
No, Bert. You took what I said out of context again. What I said was, I don't like artsy games for the sake of being artsy. They distract from the game.
No, that's not what you were referring to.
No, that is exactly what I
said. Stuff like this looks like Flash, which is negative connotation.
No. I never said
that. Just glad that, hey, it's a Sega thing.
No!
So you are.
I can't believe it. I can't believe this is happening. Either way, you're not going to detract from the greatest thing that happened to me all last week. Wonderboy Dragon's Trap. Look it up. I'll probably provide a link in the YouTube description. It looks really good. You should really try it. It's a super awesome action game.
But we can agree on something. At least it doesn't look like an old-school SNK game.
Yeah. They put work in. Looks good. You can't see it, but I'm actually glaring at Bert.
Even I can't see it.
You can't see it either. Just you feel it. Anyway, next news story. Pokemon Sun and Moon gets a lot of information, including regions, two types of Pokemon, only one of which is relevant, and something called a Zagreid got its form revealed. Let's cover these all in order, shall we? The region. Wasn't that supposed to be based on Hawaii? Didn't we cover this last time?
Yes, we did.
Okay, so let's skip that. Let's get straight to the most important news of all. And you know what it is. Iwanko.
You're right.
I want one.
The thing is, they have that customization so you can be black. That was part of the first thing that you skipped.
No, didn't we cover this, though? Make an ambiguously tan option, right?
No, you were one asking if you could, but now it's confirmed.
It's confirmed I can be ambiguously tan in this game.
Yes.
Sweet. Because black people don't exist in anime.
Damn.
I just wanted to talk about the best things.
Is a Rotom. Which I don't know what those things are.
It's a Pokemon.
Is that new to this?
No, it was a 4th-gen Pokemon. Rotom's a 4th-gen Pokemon.
This is the first time the Pokédex is actually a thing.
Yes, that's the first time where the Pokemon actually takes over the Pokédex and talks to you.
It's a little weird.
It is.
A little weird. Does that mean you catch your Pokédex?
It catches you.
Yeah, you gotta open it. You're like, well, I need to use it. I choose you, Pokédex.
No, you can't use the Pokédex as a battle thing. It's just there that it wants to be.
Oh.
Just there to help you.
Cool, I guess. I'm okay with that. I just really want to talk about
this. Yes, I know
this.
You love the Nekkoala.
Oh, no, freak you. It's all about... I can't say the name. Iwanko. Iwanko? I want one. That's what I want.
Iwanko.
This rock-type puppy thing is so fucking adorable. I love it. I want it. Yeah. Screw the starter types. I want that as my starter type.
It's almost close enough to you, you know.
Oh, maybe it'll
your
be
your YouTube character.
It might be in Moon only, though. What are you gonna do then?
Then I'll have to kill you and take your copy. That's just the way it is.
I'll trade you one, and I'll have a real dumb
and
name.
And then the other one is called the one that you could not pronounce. That thing's called Zygarde. For anyone that's not familiar with Zygarde, that was legendary for X and Y, and basically it has new forms.
It looks like a mech.
I already knew this already.
It also has a dog form.
Yep.
Yeah.
There's also a weird cell larva form and all that, and then the 50% form is what you see in X and Y.
Can I get that just for the dog form?
Yeah.
How do I get it?
I don't know.
Oh. Well then.
We don't know. They don't tell you what that is yet.
Oh. I guess it's just a Wonko, me and a Wonko. I just can't handle like they made up for that shitty fire starter for Sun and Moon with this Pokemon. They did it.
Just wait till it evolves, it's gonna look real dumb.
I'll just keep it in its cute little puppy form.
Do it.
God damn! I'm just so happy about this thing.
Just put an Everstone on it so it'll never evolve ever.
I'll never evolve it.
There you go.
Oh, it's so fucking cute. I'm sorry. And there's some sort of... Why is there a sleeping koala thing, like...
Because they don't have koalas yet. Jeez.
Drop bears, as they call them.
They need the red panda, and that's all I care about. I don't even think they have a raccoon yet.
No, they do. Golden Silver had one.
I take that back.
That weird tanuki-looking thing, I think.
That was more something else, but... I was gonna say Zigzagoon.
Oh, yeah, that thing.
The thing I always, like, destroy. They're like the ratatatatatatatatatas.
They're tatas of the Pokemon Gold and Silver world.
The most annoying thing in Pokemon Yellow at the moment. Besides all the Zubats. Freaking Zubats.
But that was really the only reason I wanted to talk about this Pokemon Sun and Moon story. Iwanko. It has my heart. You guys knew it was coming.
You'll get to see more of that when Nintendo does their E3. And speaking of that, to the next story.
Sweet. They expanded on their E3 streaming plans. More games will be shown besides Zelda, I guess.
That's where Pokemon's going to be shown. A few other things.
Yep. Pokemon Go, Pokemon Sun and Moon.
His Mirage Sessions, Fire Emblem.
Monster Hunter Generations, Dragon Quest VII, and that's about it.
Not much going for their Wii U side. They must be really, really planning hard for the NX.
The only thing I can think of for the Wii U is Paper Mario, whatever that game is.
The new one that just came out? Or is coming out? I don't even know if it's out yet.
It's coming out later.
Is it going to be the same thing as Sticker Star, one that wasn't as widely popularly received?
It'll be different. It won't be like in the first two game style.
Isn't the first two game style the one people want, though? Like Thousand Year Door and the first one?
Yes. Yeah. Then they changed it with Super Paper Mario. The only thing about Super Paper Mario I like, it has the one character I like, Mr. L. Evil Luigi.
Gotta hold that L.
That's about it.
So don't really get your hopes up for Nintendo's E3, unless you're me and looking for more information on Iwanko. Other than that, not much. I mean, I think it's probably going to show the more Zelda stuff, right? You two should really be excited for that.
June 14th will be Zelda and Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Predictions. Do you think they will show female Link as an option? Like, not Linkle, not that stupid shit. Female Link.
Oh, there's those rumors back a while ago that had it, so probably?
I just want to see the voice acting.
Oh, yeah. If all those rumors are true, then yeah, it'll have voice acting.
Oh, I don't believe that for a second. Nintendo doesn't do voice acting for Zelda. That'd be weird.
They also don't do open world stuff, and they're trying to change all the stuff different.
Uh-huh.
So we'll see.
I don't remember if you remember the last Zelda game that had voice acting in it. It didn't turn out great.
It also wasn't made by Nintendo, though.
But it had voice acting in it. You can't argue that.
It sure did.
Mm-hmm.
My boy.
Voice acting in anything way back in the day, though.
There was good voice acting back in the day. Extremely rare, but it happened. But I see your point. That's like we're going to be talking about Final Fantasy XII getting an HD remaster in 2017. I don't know, because I never played this one.
Bert, how do you feel about this, since you're the one that likes 12 more than anyone else here?
It's the one that they needed to do, since we never got the Zodiac job system version over here.
Can you explain what the Zodiac job system is, Bert?
I would love to if we ever got it over here.
But you've played the game and...
Yeah, I have. You can basically just change the classes for all the characters so you can get different moves. And, I mean, it's like old Final Fantasies where you have different jobs you can switch to and learn those moves and stuff. Basically make the characters how you want them to be.
So are you saying I could make Vaughn, yeah. Can I make him into, let's say, a monk?
I forget what classes are available, but whatever's available, then
Or Black Mage or something. Something strictly all magic.
Yeah, you can. Well,
because... Because we know how relevant Vaughn is. And Pinello.
Yes.
No matter what I hear about Final Fantasy XII, it's always about those two characters being the most pointless things ever. Like, no one likes those characters, Vaughn and whoever the other person was.
Do you want to know why?
Why?
Because they force that as your main character, but the main characters aren't those two, technically.
Mm-hmm.
It's basically Bosch and, what was her name? Ash.
Oh.
It's alright, you don't have to use Vaughn.
But... Tomaska.
I know that
you make
from
a compelling
that...
argument.
I know that from that Mega 64 skit I'm Captain Bosch from Namaska, or whatever. Do not believe whatever's lies.
Don't believe in Andor's lies.
I don't even know what that means or what the context is for that, but I just, every time I hear it, I start laughing because I think back to that Mega 64 skit. The guy running around in a...
Japanese voices.
Yeah. It's just this guy running around in a two-piece in public just screaming that for some reason.
Well, if anyone needs to know, I'm kind of, like, indifferent with 12. I like the battle system, but the story was kind of better than 13. Better than
13. You went oddly quiet on that. You want to have a witty retort on that?
For what?
Is Final Fantasy XII's battle system better than 13?
Battle system?
Yeah.
Probably?
He can't even answer that because he's too...
I like 13. It's just too easy until you do like the challenge stuff. That's when the combat system gets interesting.
Yeah, and it's like pretty much you go through the whole game until that point.
Mm-hmm. Auto battle.
Oh, I you know what? Mr. StarCraft has to hear this from you because he's struggling at a point and auto battle is not helping him. I think he's actually trying. I don't know.
Well, I mean, you know, you get the right classes also.
I gotta put you in the spotlight. But yeah.
Yes, it depends on where he's at also.
He's at that part where, let's see. It's whenever, it's close to the end. When you go back to the, I believe it was Cocoon. You remember this? That part. Somewhere there.
Well, if he's getting close to the end, it's, I mean, obviously it gets picked up.
Yeah. So maybe auto battle won't save him there.
As long as it's not turtle monsters.
Yes, we all know how much you hate the turtle monsters. The Animantoys.
They never dropped the items. Never got those ultimate weapons.
Is this also bringing back memories of Demon Souls? Please tell me it is.
Hey, that only took 4 hours.
Only, huh?
Okay.
Turtles never dropped anything.
Try harder next time, Bert.
I know.
Hey, Bert.
Don't try
harder. Hang on. Wait. Did you say you farmed turtles in Final Fantasy 13 and never got the item drop you wanted?
I did.
Maybe that ties into my hatred of grinding and wielding items in RPGs.
Yeah, that's completely optional.
It's optional,
but it's
though.
There! That's... My Bert point still
wanted,
stands.
Bert just wanted to
you don't
use
have
achievements.
To use it, though.
Yeah, point still stands. Same reason I don't like that shit in RPGs.
Yeah, but you don't have to do it, so it's fine.
I'm sure you had to for some weapon in that game, Bert.
Yeah, to get the ultimate stuff.
Mm-hmm. Just thought I'd toss my hat in on that one. Saints Row creators announced a new game called Agents of Mayhem. I don't know what to think about this trailer. Like, is this a spin-off of Saints Row, or is this a sequel, or is it just a brand new thing? It's a new thing. Okay. I kind of got nothing from the trailer, I'm going to be honest.
I wouldn't imagine that you would.
No.
Jeffrey's in there.
I was actually gonna say that. I was like, Jeffrey McWilde made a appearance, I guess. I was gonna ask, like, it just seems so odd because I know it's the crazy Saints Row people, but at the same time, it's like the trailer starts off generic bald bad guy running through robots, starts fighting some girl. With guns, who reminds me of Tracer / Mirror's Edge protagonist, just doing all this, what's it called, like, athletic shit. Then all of a sudden, here comes Pirate Man, with a fucking giant, like, anchor, or what, not an anchor, what's it called?
Harpoon.
What's that thing? What's it?
The harpoon?
Harpoon, yeah. And then afterwards, here comes Hollywood guy,
who's
treating the whole thing like a Hollywood movie, with a gun. I don't know. I'm like, what does one have to do with the other? Have to do with the other? Have to do with the other? Why are these guys mixed in? Why is there a pirate there? Why is this Hollywood guy? I don't know.
That's the point.
I know. It just, to me, it just confused. It made me ask more questions than I was like, hey, that looks fun. I was just like, why though? I'm too literal. I gotta know. But what did you guys think of the trailer? Shoot.
Who knows until we actually see gameplay?
Yeah, I was gonna say.
But the concept, did it hook you? Like, for me, like, if
I can't really say much, just looks like something I see from Overwatch.
I was gonna say, like, say for example, you watch the Overwatch trailer, any of the Overwatch trailers, and it's just like you can just watch that and be like, okay, I'm interested in what you have to show me, you know, whatever this game is. That's what I mean. Like, it didn't have that hook thing to make me go, all right, I'm interested. It just made me go, maybe I'm just dumb, but no.
More just interested in what the Saints Row people are going to make next. I guess we'll figure out. Hopefully it'll be at one of the conferences.
More than likely. It's probably already been confirmed right now, but, you know.
I mean, it's...
Or leaked.
It's already real.
At this point.
We just don't know the gameplay yet.
Yeah, that's true. It looked like it would be kind of like a team-based thing.
Nope.
You're a Team Fortress sort of thing.
Exclusively single player.
Oh, it's single player.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to be a little weird then. All right. See that? Nope. Trailer misled me. I thought it was going to be some sort of co-op game. Never mind then.
Said it's exclusively single player.
If you want a co-op game like this, I'd say Crackdown 3 would be your thing?
Speaking of Crackdown, has the new one come out yet?
No.
No.
That was announced like 2 years ago.
Announced last year.
Was it? It felt like 2 years ago, I thought. It's been a while.
We haven't even seen gameplay, like real gameplay on it yet.
Yeah. Isn't that the one where they shot the building and brought the building down? Wasn't that the big thing?
Yeah. It's supposed to use like the Xbox One cloud system.
Right, like
cloud storage or whatever, the computing. Okay. That's the only way they can make all these buildings crumble.
It'd be interesting. I would actually like to see more of that game, Crackdown.
Well, tomorrow at 11 our time. You should wake up and watch it.
Maybe I should. Maybe I'll be too dead to do that. We'll see. After this fucking podcast. Rumor. Dead Rising 4 leaked. Stars Frank West. And it's not really as much been leaked. Yeah, it's just everything's there.
Leaked already.
It's just super leaked. Everything's there.
The remake of Dead Rising 1. Mm-hmm. It's set during Christmas. It has the mall plus surrounding areas. 4-player co-op. And it's going to be revealed at Microsoft's E3 conference.
So this is going to be a Microsoft exclusive for a while, we'd imagine?
But unless we could play it.
They might put it on the PC also.
Ah.
That was the other rumor. It seems like they're trying to put games on the PC and Xbox One at the same time or something.
Yeah, if Windows 10 gaming or whatever.
Yeah. That was their little plan. So most of their big shot games were going to go on Windows and, of course, Xbox. So, like, if you want the better version of the game, PC. If you want just a playable build of the game, don't care about all the other crap, then console one is for you.
The thing is,
no bias, just straight up to the point.
Since Scoots, you played all the Dead Risings thus far, like, how do you feel about Dead Rising 4? Like, potentially, like, what could they possibly do with the game from here?
Explain how Frank West got out of Willamette.
They
didn't really explain it in Dead Rising 1. Dead Rising 1, how it ends, he's on a tank, he just punched the shit out of a general guy off a tank into, like, the zombie horde, and the person he saved is on, like, a car, like, struggling to just keep herself from getting bitten, and he's there screaming out in anger. And it ends there. And it says that he did leave, but like didn't explain that. That's where I thought Dead Rising would, kick in. Dead Rising 4.
Oh. Yeah, because correct me if I'm wrong. Dead Rising 1 was Frank West. Dead Rising 2 was the other guy.
Chuck Green.
Yeah. Was that one canon, or was the DLC that one canon?
Dead Rising 2 is canon, but the DLCs, or not DLC, but the, was it Case West?
Mm-hmm.
That finishes that storyline for Dead Rising 2. Then it goes to Dead Rising 3, which is like in the future. And Chuck Green's in that one. Spoilers.
that game's been out for a while now. Yeah. I think you're good. Yeah.
I remember seeing the story on that.
Oh, I haven't seen anything on 3 at all.
And then that's where they find the cure. That's the character, the main character for Dead Rising 3. So, and then it ends right there.
So 4 looks like it's going to be going back to Frank West, so it's going to rewind before 3?
Yep, it's going to be retelling of the first game. It's what it sounds like.
Oh. Okay. Why is it called 4 then?
It could just be a...
Like I said, it probably has elements or stuff that will explain how he gets out. And because 3, one of the characters was the character that with Frank West, and she mentioned something about him. I don't know. I guess that's supposed to explain that. That's just my guess.
Well, I mean, what even
it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Everyone just likes zombie mayhem games anyway, so just beat the crap out of zombies in the most ridiculous ways. Like a dildo cannon. Shooting dildos into zombies.
Those games are just known for wacky zombie mayhem fun. Scoots, I look forward to seeing your playthrough on it.
Okay.
Sweet.
It'll probably happen.
It's gonna happen. No, it's not probably. It's gonna happen. I know you too well.
You know me too well, huh?
I know you too well. You can't resist this one.
Where's my Dead Rising 1 through 3 playthroughs?
Yeah, do the Wii version.
No! Stop it.
Uncomfortable. Just like the next rumor. State of Decay 2.
I was gonna say, don't make me put you in the corner, man.
He'll do it. I won't stop him. But State of Decay 2 might be, or rather, to be announced, Microsoft at E3. State of Decay was that... there's so many of these types of games.
Go ahead.
They're all blending together, like, what's it called? Dying Light, State of Decay, Dead something, like... You know what I mean?
Well, yeah, they're all zombie games. They all came out whenever. Those were kind of big.
Yeah. Evil was not Evil Dead. That's a movie.
Evil Within.
That's supposed to be Evil Within. Yeah, all these games are just—they're running together to me, and I haven't played them, so I don't know which one is which. Which one was State of Decay? Was that the multiplayer one?
No,
it didn't have multiplayer.
You're thinking of Dying Light.
I must be thinking of DayZ too. I don't know. I'm a mess. I'm a zombie mess.
Yeah,
please clarify what State of Decay is
for people like me. Like a smaller team made it, and it just became huge. Like, people loved it. I mean, I've never played it. But
what's the gameplay more like? Resident Evil, or...?
No, it's like a third-person open world type thing. But it's single player. You go around making camps, set up camps and stuff, and then scavenge for supplies and stuff.
And this is really big? It took off?
It took off.
Oh. Well then, there's a sequel coming. I'm sure that one will do just as good, if not better, than the first.
Hopefully. Like, this one was very... Like, it had issues, obviously. And hopefully
team and all that?
Yeah, hopefully they make a good game for the second one.
I'd imagine with whatever success they got from the first game... They use whatever money and budget they have. Yeah, a smart team would do that, so they'll be good. Impress us, Microsoft at E3.
Yeah.
Yeah, do it. And the next story, this one is super relevant to all of us. Persona 5 releases February 14, 2017 in North America for PS3 and PS4. Two special editions are available. Sadly, neither one contained a DLC from Japan. I can say this. I got the, what's that collector's edition called? Dream Edition?
Not a clue.
The $89 one. It's like...
Take Your Heart.
Take Your Heart. Why did I call it Dream Edition? Take Your Heart Edition. And this one comes with the soundtrack CD, a 4-inch Morgana plush, 64-page hardcover art book. I love that it's hardcover. I gotta say that. Just to throw that out there, like, they don't do enough hardcover art books. They're always, like, just regular art-ass books. And it's gonna also have a steelbook and a school bag. It's a lot of stuff in there. They didn't have to do that.
I know you want that school bag.
I do, that's why I got it.
I know, you really want that school bag.
No, I have that.
You want to take it to school?
No, you see, Bert, the great thing about this school bag that you get with this special edition of Persona 5 is if you try to take that Morgana plush from me, I could easily reach into that bag of tricks and bring out some mace. You would never know, because it's disguised inside that cleverly disguised school bag.
You don't want the cat anyway.
I want it because you want it.
I'll take that answer.
Yeah. If you want it, I want it. I would normally give two shits about that cat plush, but since you really want it, I'm going to hold on to it. Make you hold that L. Yeah. And if you try to approach me, you better be careful. I could be hiding something deadly in that school bag.
Like a taser or a mace?
A mace, not a jar of mace, not a can of mace, a mace. Like the spiky ball with this.
I could see that. I could see that. Bert's just trying to take it, and you're like, oh, hell no. And you quickly just take it out and smack him in the head.
Just drop the school bag, and it sounds really heavy for some reason. Like, what the fuck's in there? All of a sudden, just come out swinging with a mace. Oh, man. It's the small things in life. Or I could just wield the very, very heavy art steel book. Or the hardcover art book and hit him with that. A lot of potential. There's a lot of potential in this collector's edition. I could. Oh, you're right.
Or you could buy that Tony Taka book and then just beat him up with
no!
that.
No! Because he'd like it. I can't hit him with things he'd like. No! You keep that shit away from me in my Morgana plush. I don't know if the special edition is still available at this point. It should be. But while supplies last, so if you are a Persona fan in general and you find yourself looking at Persona 5 going, I could get in on that. I would definitely like to show support and or get the cool stuff that comes with it. Then go ahead and drop some money down. I know it's really weird for me to say this now that I no longer work there, but go ahead and drop a pre-order. I won't say where.
You can pre-order it anywhere.
Yeah, I was going to say, I won't say where specifically to drop the pre-order, but just don't.
Unless you're in Europe.
Oh.
Yeah. We don't know how that's going to turn out yet.
Poor Europeans. Your struggle is in our hearts. We're still thinking of you guys. Don't worry. If any of you Europeans want a Morgana plush, I could send one to you. As long as this guy doesn't get it.
What if I move to Europe?
Oh, that's dedication. I might just give it to you if you do that. I might just do that. I can't wait for Persona 5. Like, how far? It's a long way away, though. If I'm gonna be honest, I was super disappointed when I saw the date. I was like, oh, next year, no.
Yep.
My heart sank. But on the bright side, I get this cool Morgana plush and art book and everything else. And sure a school do. Bag. For which to hide it all in. God, I wish I could go back to school so I could look cool with it.
Well, anyways, next story. XCOM 2 comes to PlayStation 4 and Xbox One September 6th.
Yes, it does.
Seems weird because I already assumed it was already out on those, but I guess it was just a PC release only, huh?
Yeah, so Bert, only on PC.
How excited are you to play the PlayStation 4 version of XCOM 2?
Very excited.
You don't sound excited, Bert.
Well, I'm going to play it, so there's that.
Okay.
Well, he can't get the PC version at the moment.
He sure can't.
Wreck my machine.
If only you had some sort of crazy new graphics card.
If only.
If only. Came up with VR ready. You know, came up with World of Warships. 15 days.
And a year of exploit.
Oh, and a year of exploit.
My gameplay of XCOM.
You sure could, Bert. If only there was one around.
What's stopping you?
$600 price tag.
What's stopping you?
But yeah, you can go PS4, Xbox One. It's pretty cool.
Hey, this is the only way you're going to be able to play it at this point, so.
For now, yes.
Yeah. I was going to say, yeah, because you liked XCOM, and you never got to play XCOM 2, because I always ask, like, well, how'd you enjoy it? You're like, I can't play it.
He was sad, too. He was like, I can't play it.
That was just like him. We all laughed at him. We all laughed, pointed.
He was in his corner, just twiddling his thumbs. I can't play it. I can't do it.
Super then funny.
And then he saw the GTX 1080, and then he was all like, oh my god, I wish I had that. Then I told him, hey, there's a GTX 1070. Slightly cheaper.
It's also another thing we'll talk about later.
And exactly, it'll be on here somewhere.
That's the very last thing.
It's the very last thing. You know what didn't finish last, though?
Greninja.
Who was voted the number one Pokemon in Japan.
Take that, Pikachu!
Yeah. It's time to nerf him now because he finished first. Nerf him and smash.
Do you want to know why Greninja is actually number one Pokemon in Japan?
I am dying to know why.
Because in the anime, Greninja has a new form called Ashes Greninja. Should look it up. It actually looks cooler looking.
Wait. I think I've seen a gif of this. Is this where he, like, does some Digimon shit and, like, becomes one with it?
What?
Not, like, become one. Just, his color is, like, whatever Ash is wearing, his colors goes and transfers to Greninja, and they have, like, a weird spiritual bond or some weird bullshit.
It, the Digimon.
Anime BS.
Like, I'm not even kidding. Yeah, there's some season of Digimon where the Digimon tamers and the Digimon would merge into, like, one body. I remember seeing this.
But basically, they have to have their, like, they have to be perfectly in sync to battle. They embrace that boy band, basically.
Oh, be in sync. I got it. And, let's just list them off. Number two was Arceus? Who was that?
That's the god Pokemon.
Okay. Number three was Mew, of course.
Heck yeah, better than Mewtwo.
You think so?
Dude, that thing can learn anything.
Yeah, but Mewtwo, though.
Mew.
Oh, I'll give you
I
that.
I like Mew.
Number four
was
Pikachu.
I do like Mewtwo, though.
Mewtwo is pretty cool. Pikachu is overexposed as far as we're concerned because he was the mascot for Pokemon. Still is, I guess. He's classic. And number five is Slyvion?
The fairy version of Eevee, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. Why is that?
Number 10 is the best.
What's number 10? Let's scroll down and see what this is. Number 6 appears to be some sort of praying mantis with a gun on its back.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
7 is a... it's that green snake that attacks people in Super Smash Bros. I don't know what these things are. I'm sorry. I'm the worst Pokemon trainer ever. Number 8 is some sort of crazy hypno slug. 9 is Charizard, because yes. 10 is... What the fuck is that?
It's the idol one.
What the fuck is 10? What is that?
Oh, no.
In its hair.
Oh, no.
What? I can't see what it is.
The best one.
It's a mythic Pokemon.
It looks like that weird Pokemon that all the people want to, like, bang. Grativar, or whatever it is. Is it an evolution of that?
No.
It looks like it.
It is not.
What is that?
It's an idol Pokemon. It's a pale human
with green hair. Uh-huh. The hair's music notes.
Exactly. And then when it has a form where it becomes Spanish dancer music Pokemon.
These are weird picks. Number 11 is Mewtwo, and number 12 is Eevee. I want to see the American, like, list of tops.
You know what? You know what, Justin? You know what I wish you actually had right now? I wish you had a 3DS capture device. So I want to see you have a Pokemon Sun and Moon series. I just want to see you react to every single Pokemon you ever see. It'll be great.
There is absolutely no way there will ever be a Pokemon playthrough on this channel. Ever. Never, ever.
It'll be great.
Mm-mm. That's how you piss people off right there. You play Pokemon on your channel. Everyone will hate you because you're not playing the game properly, and everyone will be mad because I keep talking about how cool my fucking dog Pokemon are and why I keep getting body because I refuse to change types.
Okay. How about streaming this on Twitch?
Never.
Just so I can hear your reactions and then be like...
You're basically wanting to watch it, so every time I have a random encounter with a Pokemon, I'd be like, what the fuck is that thing? It looks like a garbage bag filled with mango pulp.
That's actually what I want Bert to do, but we're not talking about that. Then again, Bert for Bert, if it's not a cat or a sheep type of a Pokemon.
True.
And a lesser
we're pretty much goat. The stupidest pieces. Like, we're pretty much the worst trainers ever. He's gonna stick with cat and sheep type. I'm gonna stick with dog type. We're pretty much doomed from the get go.
That's me who actually just plays the damn game.
Pretty much. Hey, like you gotta said, play how I you like it.
I want to see a Twitch thing of this.
Oh man,
it would be interesting because I would see it in a different perspective of how someone plays Pokemon.
For someone who never plays Pokemon.
Exactly. For a guy who's only played, like, Generation 1 or, to a lesser extent, 2.
Hey, you got my Gen 3 team.
By the way, you want that back?
No.
That team? I mean, I could give it back to you now.
Yes, I want the team back.
It's in my Pokemon bank just for you.
I want them.
Just so I know, what are your... I'll just say, what are three Pokemon that you guys really like? They don't have to be your favorite, top favorites.
I don't
just
know
three.
Their names.
Describe
Go-Go.
Them.
I like Go-Goat.
Okay, Go-Goat for Bert. What's the two others?
I like Mareep.
Mareep, Go-Goat, and...
And what are the others?
There's any like billions cat? Of like cats and sheep
I know,
things,
but though. I don't know their names. The only cat I know is Meow.
And Meowth, there you go.
There's Persian?
Well, yeah. I don't even like Meowth, though.
Oh, you like Persian. Skitty. You like Skitty, or D-Catty.
Sure, I'll take them all.
Alright, so three for Bert is Go-Goat, Mareep, and... What was that? Skitty?
Sure.
Alright, Scoots, your three faves, in no particular order.
Charizard? Nidoking and Bisharp.
What is a Bisharp?
It looks like a Power Ranger.
Awesome.
It's a steel dark type Pokemon, but it looks like a sheep?
Like, not sheep. Does it look like a street shark?
Oh.
With a name like that, it sounds like shark.
No, that's the Garchomp thing. That's what the street shark is.
Right.
We've been over this. For me, my top three are Arcanine, Iwanko. That's like my new favorite. I love that it's just a fucking dog with rocks on it. What is that thing? Oh. So apparently a Bisharp is just a knight. Yeah, it's just a person. It's just
that's the point. That was what it is basically.
It's a human. It's really scary. So Arcanine, Iwanko, and...
It was basically my all-time favorite 5th generation Pokemon. Because I didn't like trash bags, ice cream cone Pokemons, and all those weird shit.
Trash bags. I can't think of a third. I'll just say, fuck it.
That's a pretty good one.
That's a good Pokemon. Especially its evolution. I can't think of any. I'm actually the worst. I'll say Charizard too. There.
That's the spirit.
That's the spirit. Gotta go with the good old fires. Our next news story is Injustice 2 was officially revealed with a CG and gameplay trailer, and it's coming 2017. They, of course, have Gorilla Grodd,
Black Manta, Atrocious, I think that's what his name is, Atrocious,
mm-hmm.
Supergirl, Batman, obviously, and Superman, Aquaman.
Boo.
Whatever, he looked amazing in that trailer.
You can never make Aquaman look cool.
I don't know. He summoned a badass looking shark.
The shark was cool, not Aquaman.
Whatever.
Sorry. Superman and Aquaman will continue to hold L's for me. But
of course, the one hero that I just forgot. I don't know why, because that series was actually good. The Flash.
It's looking to be an Injustice game. A lot of people are apparently down on this one because the graphics aren't up to par. And I just said no. That's just the way they've always looked.
I got something else to link you.
The best Superman
model ever. There you go. Have fun with that.
Yeah, everybody's like, man, Supergirl's face looks awful. I'm like, have they never played a fucking NetherRealm game before? They don't know how to model women's faces there.
I was going to say, it improved.
Could you? Oh my god, what is this thing you've linked me? What is that? Is that supposed to be Superman?
That's Superman. That's what his model looks like.
Oh my god.
This is on the Injustice mobile game, but that's how his face looked.
Oh, it shows. Link this to Bert. Have you seen this?
Yeah.
Is that Superman? That looks nothing like him. That's awful. I might just make this the thumbnail, just a really zoomed in shot of that face. He's so downtrodden.
Would you like an Aquaman one, too?
No, I think this is enough.
I think that was better, too.
Oh my god. That is probably the worst Superman I've ever seen, ever.
The Aquaman looks
kind of like a shitty version of Aquaman, but this Superman is just...
Damn!
It's sad.
I hate Aquaman.
I don't like Aquaman.
He has feelings.
Is it bad that
I like Black Manta more than Aquaman?
No. Anyone's better than Aquaman.
But that's Aquaman's bad guy.
Again, everybody around Aquaman is better than Aquaman.
Damn.
They tried cutting off his hand and giving him a hook. Tried giving him the long-haired, rugged look. Just
made him half-human, half-Atlantean. Give him a personality.
Silly underwater man. I just can't. I mean, it looks Injustice-like. Bert, I know you lost your shit when you saw Supergirl. She's like your favorite.
What? Why would I like Supergirl?
You know you're the hardcore DC fanboy over here. He likes this shit.
He likes Atrocious. Atrocious.
He has that floating spirit cat.
That's his teammate. It's not a spirit cat. It's a floating spirit cat. It's an actual cat that can fly because of the red ring.
Well... Like
and it is a very vicious freaking cat.
Like all cats.
It's a sociopath. It's a sociopath hell-bent on ripping your face open.
I like it.
Like all cats. Wake me when they add a dog character into Injustice.
No, why would they do that?
Because I'm sure DC has a dog superhero, and if it doesn't, then therein lies the problem.
Does Marvel?
Yeah.
Who?
Cosmo. If you don't know who it is, then I'm sorry, Bert.
Of course I don't know who it is.
Yeah. That's a dog character. Anyway. You know what else is a problem? Kingdom Hearts not getting to 3 already. Kingdom Hearts 2.8 trailer shown. They really, really just need to stop and just get to 3 already.
These are basically 3. You may as well just live with it.
I'm literally... Because I've said this millions of times beforehand. I don't think I've ever mentioned on podcast, but I'm going to say it here. And I don't care for any of the 2.H's, 2.2's, and 2.3's. I just want 3. I literally don't care anymore. Just want 3.
There you go, Bert. There's your cat.
I played Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2. I played Chain of Memories. And afterwards, they kept doing the little handheld games, and I was like, no. Can we get 3 now? But they just kept HD-ing everything and kept redoing it. Which is fine. HD remakes are fine, so everybody can get updated. You know, for those who didn't have a PS2 back in the day. But they just keep doing these, man.
To make the story kind of make sense, which it doesn't.
It's a mess. At this point, I'm just playing 3 to get to the Disney World.
Well, anyways, it basically has the thing that goes after Birth by Sleep, which explains Aqua. The second one is basically Dream Drop Distance Remastered, which sets it's the prequel to Kingdom Hearts 3. Well, it sets up what Sora's even doing in Kingdom Hearts 3. And then there's the weird movie thing. I guess that's like the prequel to everything that explains the Keyblade Knights, Warriors, whatever.
They gotta get another game out before 3, I guess. So you think they're probably gonna do a 2.9 before 3 comes out, of course.
Let me just let you know one thing. That Dream Drop, or not Dream Drop, I mean the Birth by Sleep thing, that's basically a demo of Kingdom Hearts 3, technically. If you really want to go into accuracy.
But do I really want to play a not 3, though?
You can just wait until 3. They probably have, like, a giant thing that explains everything.
Oh, I don't doubt it. Remember Kingdom Hearts 2? Or how long it took to get to the actual game?
Yep. Actually, no. Kingdom Hearts 2 didn't even really explain all the Chain of Memories and all that other crap.
No, I don't think it did. It just kind of left it hanging there, but I guess that was for all the multiple prequel sequels or whatever. So, I guess we're getting closer, kind of getting caught up now. Watch Dogs 2 trailer shown. Did people really want this after Watch Dogs? Kind of being not as, you know, living up to the promises of the initial trailers and all that?
Probably not, but at least they get a second chance.
A second chance? You think that... Here's the thing, because, Bert, you already know about it. Scoots, did I ever show you the Ubisoft downgrade video? Did you ever see that?
The what?
The Ubisoft downgrade video?
No, I haven't.
It's basically a side-by-side comparison of what Ubisoft games look like at, like, E3 and all those test things when they show, like, the games off and everything. That's supposed to be in-game footage and everything. And what it looks like when it actually comes out. It's pretty amazing. My favorite is the, what was it? The Watch Dogs one, the preview one they showed, like, what's the main character of the first Watch Dogs? The guy with the cap.
Aiden Pierce.
The iconic cap. How could I forget his name? Walking down the street, and it's like, it's super dark, the lighting's amazing, and it's like, lights are flickering, there's like, dirt and garbage rolling across the street. It looks like something out of a movie. And then it shows like the gameplay, what the game looks like actually next to it, side by side. That same scene, that same area, like nothing looks the same. It looks so watered down compared to what they showed. Like there's no garbage, no lights flickering. It looks like a PS2 game in comparison, or a Vita game. It's really hilarious. I'll link it to you sometime soon. Remind me to do that. But yeah, hopefully Watch Dogs 2 doesn't suffer from that. I know they like to hype, like Ubisoft is really good at hyping their stuff up like that, but it kind of hurts their product in the long run if it can't live up to the hype. Because then bad word of mouth. I don't know if that's what happened with the first Watch Dogs, though.
Yeah, it was just a bad game and no one else wanted to play it after.
But that game had, like, shitloads of hype going into it, remember?
Yeah,
all like, the shit they showed that you could do in that game, the hacking and the world is your playground, you know.
I know what happens when you have launch-style games.
Hopefully Watch Dogs 2 will actually have a Watch Dog minigame where you can actually watch dogs, as I've said to Bird earlier.
You can.
Yes. I told you, and I want all the dogs to have separate AIs, each one that does their own thing. Make the game interesting.
Each one you shoot in the head dies.
Nope. They're all invincible. And then when you shoot them, they go to heaven because they're like, all dogs go to heaven. Watch Dogs 2. Look forward to it. It's got hipster dancing in it. And the next news story we're actually caught up now. Well, we talked about the Sonic crossover last week, but this isn't the crossover, but it's a thing that's happening. You remember Lego Dimensions, guys?
Yep.
Yep, I know this whole thing.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
So apparently, joining the likes of Batman, again, and Gandalf, and Lego Movie Girl, are going to be the Ring character. What's his, Gollum?
Smeagol, Gollum, yeah.
Yeah, Smeagol, Gollum. Slimer from Ghost in the Shell, Ghostbusters.
And the Ghostbusters.
And was it the female ones or the mm-hmm. old ones?
The female ones.
Female ones, okay. Who else was it? Trying to remember off the top of my head from that trailer.
Powerpuff Girls?
What?
Yeah, they were mm-hmm. in there.
Were they in there? I don't remember them.
Teen Titans Go.
All right. Adventure Time with Finn and Jake. Yep. Finn and Jake, basically.
Beetlejuice.
E.T. for some reason. Beetlejuice, yeah. The A-Team, the Goonies, Harry Potter, Knight Rider, a whole bunch. But let's get to the reason this is brought up. Because of me. Sonic is in there.
Hey.
He's not supposed to be a Lego.
He's not supposed to be that humanoid.
It's not great, Bert.
But he definitely steals rings.
He sure did. Why? It looks so jarring to see him like this. I've never seen Lego Sonic before, and I'm not sure I want to now.
I think you need to buy that.
I'm probably gonna get it. Yeah.
You need to do it. You're probably gonna Sonic do it. Fan.
I gotta do it.
Why you do that? Buy Black Knight.
No. like Lego shit yes is it. Already overpriced. Like, holy hell. So I'm even rethinking my plan of buying the Sonic Lego stuff. Like, you remember back in the day when we were all kids, and like a bucket of Legos, like a 300 bucket of Legos, was like $5 or $10. And now when you go to the store and you see like Legos, they're like $60 for like a licensed playset that has like 30, 50 Legos in it at best.
Yeah.
I know the licensing and everything is probably why it's so expensive, but holy hell. Legos are an investment now. And I think Lego Dimensions, if I remember correctly with the price tags, each character set cost $15, I believe. $14.99. And the base game, I can't remember what the price was on that. We actually need the portal and everything. So no, we'll not be investing in this, even though it has Sonic in it. Sorry. Hopefully the Legos look better than they did in the trailer. Hopefully. That's all there is to say on that. That's all there is, guys.
All she wrote.
All she wrote. I have nothing else to say on it, even though there's Sonic in it. The next story is KG Inafune expresses regret over Mighty No. 9's delay, and he's looking forward to the sequel, though. Now, slow down, Mr. Inafune. The game still isn't even out yet. Oh, man, this guy is sure is eager to get working on that next game. But anyway, here's what he said. Quotes are, "We deeply apologize to the fans and backers for having taken much longer than expected. I learned again how difficult it is to make a game." And the next quote was, "The reason of delay was not because we were short-handed, but due to how we were going to sell it. And then biting more than we can chew after declaring it will be released after all or for all hardware. But it was good learning experience." And there's two more quotes, but you kind of you kind of get the gist of, I fucked up.
Gotta
I
learned my lesson. Last quote.
The last one you think is important?
Mm-hmm.
Last quote is, one more thing I'd like to say is that Mighty No. 9 is a set of contents, meaning it's not just a game. We're also moving forward in an anime and live-action film for it. Development for a sequel is already in our minds, and we all share the feeling of we'll do it even if it doesn't sell.
What is that?
Mmm.
Damn it.
Mmm.
Got that anime, live-action, and even if this bombs, he's gonna make a sequel.
Man, that is, that, for those of you that aren't aware, we're kind of all having a little cringe fest here. We're not really sure how to feel in this matter. Scoots, we are playing Mighty No. 9, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I think so.
Yeah.
I'm just going to say, okay, businessman, okay, businessman.
Okay, businessman. All right, that quote still stands, man. It still stands. He is not a game. He's not a game creator. He is a businessman. Wow, an anime. I thought the anime was just for Red Ash. I thought Red Ash was the Mega Man Legends spinoff of Mighty No. 9, and then Red Ash was getting an anime. That was a kickstart,
great, isn't it?
Like, man.
And this is the first I heard about the live action.
Yeah, me too. I was reading the quote, I had like a moment when I was like, ugh. But,
yeah, it seems like live action is becoming, like, a popular thing in Japan with all their things.
I don't know why. Probably because it's cheaper to do than CGing it.
I guess more creative freedom?
Maybe? The Attack on Titan movies were live action, if I remember correctly, and those got mixed reviews.
Because it's live action.
Yeah.
Probably cheaper to do, too.
Yeah, there's a lot of things you can do with live action that are cheaper than making a full-blown CG thing. There's a... Yeah. Man, this Mighty No. 9 thing is... It's coming out soon, though. Man, we're getting close to that release date, but...
Tell me again, when is that release date?
Man, I'm glad you asked. The release date for this is going to be June 21st. In Japan and North America, but Europe will have to wait 3 days for June 24th. And it'll be out on everything. PS4, PS3, Xbox One, 360, Wii U, and PC.
Anyways, yeah. To the next story.
Yeah, let's just...
Before we get...
Halo Wars 2 Open Beta to begin on June 30th... not 13th for Xbox One. Apparently this, you know... It's a hell of a leak.
Yep, they're probably going to reveal that on their conference, and it's available now.
And everybody's kind of, you know, I can just imagine them being like, fuck, it happened again! How did they keep...
And then you'll have this one random, like, Halo Wars fan going,
yeah.
Oh, God, like the freaking Bethesda conference.
Dude, there was one fan that just was all like, fuck yeah! Hell yeah! That's all I kept hearing. And I was like, okay.
That would be... Bert, let's be honest. Let's be honest here. That would be you if you were there. If you were at a Bethesda thing. You love Bethesda.
What?
Yeah, you do. You play them all, the Bethesda games.
You are a worshipper of Bethesda.
You love Bethesda.
Minus the Doom.
How am I a worshipper of Bethesda?
You played them all. And you love them all. You don't stop talking about them.
Besides, we're talking about Halo 2 here.
Halo Wars 2, thank you very much.
Jeez, you're going to make people like freak out here. Like, Halo War, Halo 2.
And he got Halo 2 in the Master Chief Collection.
And it's going to be made by the Creative Assembly team, which are the guys behind Total War.
There was also another rumor about Halo 3 being remastered, but we'll see.
It's already mostly remastered.
We'll see.
Scoot, seeing as you have the Xbox One out of all of us, will you be playing the Halo Wars 2 beta?
Yes.
Better free up that 13 gigs.
It's a big one.
I got 500 gigs on my system, and I got 3 terabytes on my actual external, so I'm good. I'm good.
Let Bert play it too, because he has to get his hands on this. You liked Bert, Wars, right, Bert?
Do what?
Did you like Wars, or was it another Halo that you liked?
Wars is okay. I never finished it.
Oh.
You know what you need to do, Mr. Bert? When Halo Wars comes out for PC, we'll both play that.
I require buying it. I don't know if I'd want to buy it.
No, don't worry about that.
I'll rent it for PS4.
Like I said, don't worry about buying it.
Don't worry your pretty little head over it.
When we get to that point, I'll do something about it.
You must really want to play Halo Wars 2.
We need to play something together. If it has to be Halo Wars 2, it'll be that.
Or if it'll even have co-op story. Guess we'll find out.
I don't care. We can just kill each other in that game. I don't care. It'll never do anything.
True. It also looks very cartoonish. You see the screenshots.
Yep.
Very colorful.
Ooh. This next story.
All right, breaking news, guys. Everyone, no, it just broke. As we were doing this podcast, it just happened. Berserk is getting a freaking Mozu game. It's happening.
That's been...
Well, no, Bert, shut up. This is official now. It's official.
I know, I put the official part there like an hour or two ago.
No, it just happened. Don't break kayfabe. It just happened. Breaking news. Now we finally get a Berserk game. Ever since the one on Dreamcast, it's finally happening. This is gonna be a fucking dark game.
Mm-hmm.
Horrific too. I hope it's super violent like the actual manga.
It will be.
With like baby eating villains. I'm not even making that up. First villain literally eating a baby on the manga. I need this in my life. This is going to be a horrible, horrible thing if they do it correctly. And they can do it, too, because it's Koei Tecmo.
Mm-hmm.
This is what they specialize in. So, yeah, that's the breaking news on that one. Just broken. Finally. Not only are we up to date, but it's happening as we're doing it. Live. This might as well be live. That's all there is to say on that. Bert, seeing as you play all the warrior-type games... Your samurai warriors, your dynasty warriors, and this is going to be Berserk based on that. Are you interested? Do you even follow Berserk at all? Or
I've seen a bit of it back in the day, but I don't know much about it, so.
Oh. But yeah, you will play it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. What about you, Scoots? You in?
I'm in. I like
you ready
Berserk.
For some fucking Black Knight action?
Hell yeah, I am.
Oh, let's do it. I can't wait. I'm actually excited for that. I can actually start reading the manga, because I heard like it started up again.
It's still in the process. I mean, it did, but at the same time, it's really slow, the updates.
I mean, there's a lot to go through before I catch up, so... I started reading it a couple months ago.
Because right now, they actually got to the island place that they were trying to go to.
Oh, yeah, okay, that's what I keep hearing. I just wanted to make sure, because I...
They finally made it to that island place, but, like, that's where it stopped.
they made progress just to stop.
They gave people blue balls!
Again. Alright. We're getting close here. Next news story is ReCore, which launches September 13th. This is... KJ Inafune and the makers of Metroid Prime.
Businessman.
Okay. I've seen these things. I'm looking at the box art of ReCore. Are those claptraps?
Mm-hmm. No.
Because that thing that looks like a dog looks like a claptrap. And so is that one on the very right.
It's just a robot.
Doesn't it look familiar, though?
Are you saying it looks like a claptrap because it's yellow?
Maybe. I don't know. Maybe. That's probably what it is. I'm looking at screenshots. This is an indie game, yeah, I hope?
No.
Oh.
Makers of Metroid Prime and Keiji Inafune.
Oh. It looks a little barren from these screenshots, Bert.
supposed to be. It's a desert.
There's no texture on the sand, Bert.
That's supposed to be. It's a desert.
There's sand? Blood on the sand? What?
50 Cent blood on the sand. There's nothing, Bert. This game looks... Okay. Are you defending it? Is that what you're doing?
Are you having issues with honest screenshots instead of fake ones?
Yes, actually lied to me. Watchdog me, damn it. Honest screenshots, Bert.
What?
It looks like a video game, I guess. So, Keiji Inafune, with his hand in multiple projects, he's keeping busy, that's for damn sure.
He should still focus on the one game that, you know, he's actually doing.
Right, Red Ash.
Yes! That's the
Mighty one. Number 9, I meant.
No, Red Ash, what are you talking about?
Right, that one.
Anyways.
Oof. Finally, the last news story.
You're gonna get excited.
Am I?
I don't know.
This last news story is Walking Dead, rather, the Telltale Walking Dead Season 3 has been revealed.
Oh, you don't sound happy.
Scoots, it's a mixed feeling I'm feeling right now. Like, I enjoyed the first season, you know, before... I enjoyed the first season before it happened. I mean, I'll just say spoilers at this point. If you haven't played the Telltale Walking Dead games, you're way behind. So spoiler alert if you haven't played The Walking Dead Season 1 or 2. But I like Season 1. I thought having a character protecting a child was a good kind of thing to cement you to the world. You care for the characters, more or less, some more than others. And I thought it was pretty good the way it ended. Like, kind of a good... The way The Walking Dead in general would handle that sort of thing was pretty good. It's different from the way the comics handle everything in the TV show. To actually have, like, a sentimental moment between characters like that. So I thought Season 1 was great. Season 2, not so much. And I don't know if it's because Clementine herself... as a character now, kind of makes it harder to, I don't know, I just don't feel as strongly for Season 2 as I did Season 1, and I'm thinking Season 3 is probably going to be worse for me, besides the fact that they're going to have to cheat their way to make sure all these paths that everybody took with the multiple endings of Season 2 somehow has to all go back to one point again. So that'll be interesting, I guess. I would like to play the game just to make Clementine a complete and total sociopath. Just make her an insane dictator. But in the end, I know it's all going to be the same. So that's kind of why I'm kind of down on it right now, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I guess that's probably why I enjoyed Season 1 so much, because it felt like that one at the time. Felt like, oh, my choices really did matter, even though if you replay it, you're like, oh, they really didn't. But playing through the first time and then seeing, you know, your ending play out like that was pretty good. So after now that I know what to expect and, like, well, I see where the path is branching if I make this choice, and then you kind of, your mind starts working differently when you're playing it with that mentality, and I don't think I can immerse myself in the games anymore. So Season 3 is iffy on me. That's my fucking write-up on Walking Dead Season 3. Is anything you guys want to add to that?
Nope. But
nope.
They do have the Telltale Batman game that got revealed also.
Oh, God.
Telltale is getting their hands in many, many, many projects like Keiji Inafune. Only they finish their products and get them out when they should.
It should be the Batman. They should be the villains, not Batman.
Actually, that's a much better idea, Scoots, that she said that.
You should be, like, the villain, the bad guys, and, like, try to avoid Batman.
That way you could do fucked up shit to people, and it could really be fucked up.
A reversed
Mm-hmm. Can't do it when you're Batman. You can't kill people when you're Batman. So that fun is already going to be gone from that game. Mash A to torture this suspect while you hold him over the ledge, but don't drop him.
Unless you're
alien. Batman can't kill him.
Unless you're a robot or a robotic alien, he won't murder you.
Exactly. No, I won't kill a human, but I'll murder the fuck out of that alien.
Because I've seen Batman do that many times in every movie, show, whatever.
That being said, now...
He didn't even hesitate into, like, destroying Darkseid's planet.
Apocalypse and Darkseid all starting to mesh together now.
This is what happens when you, like, DC and Marvel.
He started getting mixed up. Well, that concludes the gaming news, and here we go into...
Oh, jeez.
A segment never seen before in this podcast. This really is a mega cast. And that's basically going to be covering what the E3 press conferences are. And Bert? These E3 press conferences go in this order that's listed here, yeah? Or at least these are the ones happening today, right?
These are the ones that already happened.
And unfortunately, Bert, you're going to be the one probably going over most of this, because I didn't really get to watch the E3 press conference, unfortunately.
And I don't care.
We all know you're a dying dislike of EA.
Oh, yes.
Except for Plants vs. Zombies.
I liked it before EA got them, damn it.
That's why I said that.
Okay. Anyway.
Okay, go ahead, Bert.
Justin has to read them.
Alright, so the E3 press conference, Titanfall 2, which is going to launch October 28th for PS4, Xbox One, and PC, Madden 17.
Well, go out of time.
I'm sorry, did you want to talk about Titanfall 2?
Well, it's a big deal because the first one was exclusive for Xbox One and PC, but now they're on PS4 also.
Oh, I didn't notice that. Sorry, my eyes glazed over because I read EA.
You love it.
Maybe I have to do this.
And they're actually going to have a single-player campaign this time, so... It looks good.
Can I ask you something, Bert? Did they ever mention anything about cross-platform play with Titanfall 2? No?
They did not.
Okay. That was worth a shot.
I have a crap on it now. No, there's a lot more movement.
I can pull people in.
Yeah, that is true. You can scorpion people.
Get over here! The guy will be like, no!
It might pull you to them, not them to you. I'm not sure.
Or maybe we throw two grappling hooks at each other, then we just...
Oh, no. What would happen?
Who knows?
Grappling hook exception. Yep, they got, like, 6 robots now instead of 3. That's cool. I don't know. It looks like that, more Titanfall, and that's
fine. Processing power, bro.
Power of the PS4.
Oh, jeez. Okay, I'll do the next one. Next story. Madden 17 announced.
Next story.
Next story. Yawn. Basically announces an esports initiative.
Yep, it's kind of like... The Capcom Pro Tour, but for EA games.
Yeah, for football.
They'll have sports stuff. They showed, like, Battlefield also, so I guess
for sports ball.
Whatever.
Guess they'll do that also.
We don't talk about their shooters. We talk about their sports games, because remember, EA Sports.
It's in the game. Ugh. I hate myself for saying that slogan now.
Go back in your corner.
I am so sorry.
No, go back in your corner.
No! You can't put me there, damn it.
The more you talk, the more we gotta keep going on about EA.
Okay.
Anyways, Bert.
Mm-hmm.
Next story. This is one I actually care about.
Yes.
Mass Effect Andromeda was mentioned again. More info.
Yeah. They kind of did what they did last year, where they said, hey, look, video game, and nothing. They just showed a short 2-minute trailer.
It's okay. I'll take anything.
It, I mean, it looks good if that's actually what the game is going to be, but we have no idea. Shut up, Justin.
I'm sorry.
You can't do this to me. Then the next story. FIFA 17 announced. Next story.
No. No. We gotta talk about FIFA.
No. I don't want to talk about football.
I will say that they have story modes for the stuff now, which they've been doing for like the UK basketball stuff and all that stuff.
Oh, so I can make a story about Ricky against his friend Javier. And how he has the need to kick the soccer ball.
Alright, next story. We'll just run over that.
I'm sorry.
Alright.
This is for you, Justin. Right.
Don't wrestle my jimmies further.
What, this next one?
Okay, you want me to read it? EA Originals there. Program. Help indie developers make game. Oh, this is some bullshit right here. I never read this until just now. I just read that.
And click on the link so you can see what the game that they announced was. It's something that's up your alley.
Mm-hmm. Okay, just stall for time.
Artsy and stuff.
Son of a bitch! What? This is the shit I'm talking about right here.
Wait, so you're saying stuff like Ori and the Blind Forest is garbage?
Listen to me. You can't do this to me.
The exact same thing if that's what an image popped up and showed.
No. What yes. I said was, Bert, and don't you twist it, I said games that are artsy for the sake of being artsy detract from the game to me and make it awful.
Yeah, this isn't being artsy to be artsy. That's just
you don't say.
No.
When I look at a game, say, Ori and the Blind Forest or whatever, to me... No, you know what? I'm not getting into this. No, we can do this all night, Bert. Let the listeners know about EA, and I'll go back to my corner where I belong.
Well, apparently they're going to give 100% of... They're going to help these people make their games, obviously. They're going to give all the profit to the developers.
Bullshit.
And what I'm guessing is it'll mean that it's going to be like the PC versions are going to be stuck on Origin. Which would probably make sense.
That's the catch. So basically EA is cutting out the middleman of trying to buy out every creative studio and killing them. They're just going to be like, instead of us destroying everything that you love, we're just going to just program on our stuff. But the catch is you have to put it on our stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, that looks kind of cool. See how that turns out.
We're going back to something I actually care about again.
There's so much Star Wars.
So many Star Wars games.
They have games planned all the way to like 2018 already.
Oh, Jesus. The Star Wars fandom is all like, yes. Then, the video game fan in me is all like,
Yeah. Lots of Star Wars stuff. Hopefully everyone's excited. Can at least be one a year.
There's so many Star Wars.
Uh-huh.
So many Star Wars.
And then we finally got to see gameplay for Battlefield 1. Which looks like Battlefield.
It is Battlefield.
Surprise, surprise.
Battlefield.
Not a sign of trenches anywhere.
What?
Nope.
I am a disappointment.
It's just Battlefield with a World War I skin on it.
Disappoint. It's World War I. It's supposed to have trench warfare.
Well, maybe a different map will have trenches, but the ones they show, or the one that they showed, did not. And yeah. They have like an hour of gameplay up. Or if anyone who's interested, probably already seen it if you were.
No, I have to watch this here soon.
Yeah, they had a whole bunch of celebrities come, like Snoop Dogg and stuff. It was a thing. And that was EA. You can come out of your corner now.
Yes. Can I?
What?
Can I have a word about EA, though?
No. If you want, it's your podcast.
It sure is. You can't do this to me on my podcast, damn it. God damn it, EA. Why do you continue to be the biggest company? Why don't you do... Is there any chance we might get sponsored by EA at some point on this podcast? Should I just... You know, we'll get back to them another time. You sneak in, yeah, we'll see. But here's the Bethesda E3 press conference. So they have Quake Championships announced for PC. More info at QuakeCon in August.
They do.
QuakeCon. Isn't that usually in Texas?
I have no idea where it's at.
I think it's always usually in Texas somewhere.
Yeah, with how well Doom did, I think people are really excited to see what they're going to do with Quake. And they're promising like 120 FPS.
Do you really need that much FPS?
Yes.
For first-person shooters, yeah.
Yes.
Really?
A lot of people play like up in the like 200s.
Wow.
Teleportation, yeah.
Shabba-da-ba-ba. Then afterwards, it'll be the Elder Scrolls Legend card game, which was shown. It'll be available on PC, Mac, and mobile.
Yeah, they announced this last year, but I don't think they had too much info. But I still don't even know what it's about, but it's on mobile, PC, and Mac.
Oh, it's a electric card game?
It's a card game.
I was hoping it was an actual card game, like where you actually have to go out of the store, buy some cards, look at the cards. If you see some similar cards, you'll be like, son of... You can do that.
It's just it's got to be digital.
But I want physical cards.
Sorry. It's not happening.
How is it supposed to cater my Yu-Gi-Oh? Oh, fuck. My Yu-Gi-Oh! See, I mentioned the Yu-Gi-Oh! And I'm just kind of...
His Konami-ness came out and everything fucked up.
Magic!
Yeah.
Like, look at the Magic cards.
They're still around. In droves.
The collector in me just collects all those cards. Think of the Pokemon cards. Think of it.
I'm also thinking of the Fallout 4 DLC, which is announced. More of that coming soon.
But that doesn't have Pokemon cards or Magic cards.
DLC. You're going to be able to build your own vaults. It'll be kind of like that Fallout Shelter thing, but inside Fallout.
So if you enjoyed Fallout 4, get ready to have your adventure renewed yet again.
Be ready to build a vault.
Then there's Fallout Shelter, which is coming to PC. New update in July.
Yeah, they're adding stuff to the existing game, and that'll all be coming to PC also.
Oh, yeah. This is what you always wanted to do, Bert. You wanted to play Fallout Shelter.
I sure did.
Just like my coworkers. My coworkers were all about Fallout Shelter. That's all they would do. For the longest time until it got old, and then Fallout 4 came out, and they were like, that's about it.
Then the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Remaster officially revealed with mods on consoles.
And PC.
Mm-hmm. And if PC. You own all the DLC on PC, you get it for free.
Oh, oh man.
So there's that.
I'm missing one DLC.
No free for you.
What DLC do you think I'm missing?
You're missing the house building one.
Well, yeah, there's that. There's another one.
The one where you ride dragons and stuff?
That's a DLC?
Yeah, it's part of one of them. I can't remember what it's called, though.
Oh, yeah, that's the one, yeah. The one where you go to Morrowind?
Yeah, I believe so.
That's the one, yep.
Don't forget that Prey was announced for Xbox One, PS4, and PC. There's going to be more at QuakeCon.
When I saw that, right, I was like, oh my god, they brought that back, and it's not Prey 2.
No, it doesn't quite look like the thing everyone was hyped about either.
What? Oh. Oh.
Man, I could show you Prey. The one I played. The one you technically could not really die.
The spirit world stuff to resurrect yourself?
Yeah, you shoot the crap out of the spirits with the bow. Then you become reborn.
Here it is.
Hey, at least it's better than... Do you remember the darkness?
The darkness is fine.
You always get that stupid thing. It was like, you cannot die. I will not let you.
it's fine.
It doesn't sound fine to me, Bert. There's new updates for Doom. Snapmap upgrades and classic deathmatch. And Doom is the only thing from Bethesda I care about right now.
Classic deathmatch.
Yeah. What Quake will be for?
I just want that Doom single.
Just making sure. Classic deathmatch is the one where they have weapons all over the place and people fight to the death to get to the weapons.
I doubt they'll do it that way.
They need to do it that way.
I think it's just going to be free for all.
I'm just saying, they need to do it that way so people don't have loadouts and automatically have the weapons. They have to fight for it!
I don't think they're gonna do that.
And there'll be one OP player that will have all the weapons. He'll kill everyone. And then everyone will be like, this is some bullshit! And then that one guy will be like, yes, yes.
It'll be exactly like that.
There you go.
I can't wait to see your Doom multiplayer playthrough, Scoots, because this sounds exciting. The Elder Scrolls Online debuts, Dark Brotherhood questline. Sorry, I apparently am having a heart attack as I'm saying this. Available Sweet this week. Mother. One Tamriel comes this fall. Experience all content.
Tamriel.
What the heck is this?
It's think of like an RPG where you know, like you have level 1 areas, and as you go, you get level like 10 areas.
And you use this little pass or something that it bumps your character all the way up to like, let's say, the level that most people are, like 50 or something. It'd be like level 1 all the way to 50. So you'll have everything.
Yeah, so you can explore anywhere whenever you want.
Oh, yeah. So you don't have to just hit, you're not stuck at the beginning areas when everybody else is doing the
basically,
new stuff.
It's basically so I don't have to be stuck in Morrowind forever!
Yeah, like say you want to go visit a different area, but normally it would be like 50 levels higher than you. You can still go there.
Maybe I want to go to Daggerfall, or maybe I want to go to Cyrodiil. No, I can't because I'm stuck in Morrowind. Man, salty again. I'm a salty iguana right now.
An iguana, huh?
It's a restaurant.
Okay. See, I thought it was something. I thought you were going somewhere else. Like Bethesda's VR, Doom, Fallout 4 were announced for it. Did we really need Fallout 4 and Doom? Actually, Doom, I can imagine VR.
You
want to
talk about
fun.
Stuff that'll sell VR?
Actual games, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You know who doesn't have a VR? Anything?
Everyone?
Yeah.
Everyone but you? Because you have a fucking new graphics card that does all
but
those things?
But I don't have the VR system. And that's like another, like, how much is that, Bert? Like
$500? A lot.
But you have $800? The potential to do it. I don't.
The funny thing about this is it'll only be on the Vive.
Oh.
Because I believe Bethesda is currently in a lawsuit with Oculus.
That would sour the relationship.
So, yeah, it's probably not coming to the Oculus.
Not until that is settled and some asses are kissed.
We don't need the Rift. It's bad.
Yeah, they don't need it. Who needs that Oculus anyway?
It's too rifty.
Already like, choosing sides.
Not really.
I mean, he can because he has the potential to pick whichever
because
one he wants.
It's Facebook owned.
It is.
Do you not see the Facebook,
you love Facebook
conference where they show the what to do? Conference. They had a Facebook conference explaining what they were going to do with the Oculus Rift with their Facebook thing. They said you could make 3D interactive selfies.
That sounds cool.
You can link it all together so the person that is viewing it through VR can experience what you're experiencing.
Power of technology.
And you can look around in a 360 motion or whatever and see everything in the 360 motion.
I love view. 360 motion view.
So, like, if I was in Philippines, right, and I take a picture of, like, my surrounding area. Like, if I was in, a Sega arcade, and I send it to Justin, then he had VR magically, and he sees this. He would be able to see what is around me, all the arcade machines around me, and then he could just be all like, I want to be there.
That sounds like exactly what I'd say, too, if I got a picture like that.
And then you could draw pictures on that, and then I can add on to it and put a tie on that picture. Because you can do that. The power of technology and the Oculus Rift.
You just sold me on an Oculus Rift, and you were supposed to be trying to make it sound awful compared to the other ones. You know what is awful?
I do. That's what I do.
Bert's favorite game, Dishonored 2. It's got gameplay revealed, and it's going to be on PS4, Xbox One, PC on November 11th.
Oh, we could talk about Dishonored 2, especially when my freaking wisdom tooth chipped. Due to me yawning, and next thing you know, in the middle of those Dishonored
2, that boring for you? You had to yawn? What's it?
Oh my
well,
god, was
to
it?
To be fair, I woke up from a lot of things because I was too worn out from work, and I woke up around this time, and then I was yawning, and then next thing you know, crack! Didn't even make a crack, it just felt weird, and then next thing you know,
it was during Dishonored 2?
I put my tongue up against the wisdom tooth, and then it's just like in pieces, and I'm like, spit it out, and I'm all like, what the crap is this? And I have it on my desk still, too. It's right there, it's just...
You should have put it in milk. You could have saved that tooth. Oh my god.
Maybe this is the problem. Maybe this is the reason why... This wisdom tooth is just cracking because I'm not putting milk on that tooth in general.
Yeah, you gotta rub some calcium on it.
I don't think that's how that works.
Yeah.
But no, it's impacting and it sucks.
Oh my god.
I need to get it removed. But whatever. Go back to Dishonored 2.
I'm sorry.
I don't know if I can after that.
Yeah, like Dishonored 2 confirmed so boring that Scoots yawned his tooth out.
Whatever, it had the best gameplay mechanic ever, where you travel back and forth between time.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That was pretty awesome, Bert.
Yeah, but Bert didn't play Dishonored the way he should have.
I played it the way I needed to.
Yeah, well, your way was dumb. And I hate you for it.
You know, that's how he's going to play Deus Ex.
Right? Of course, that's how you play Deus Ex. And you played Dishonored also. Watch the gameplay reveal. That's exactly what I would have done.
Well, they're wrong.
Yeah, you even had... Okay, so you even shoot a person in the ass many, many, many times?
No, I'll be non-lethal.
Because the guy did that.
I won't kill
him. He let that dude's butt up with that gun.
He sure did.
It's okay, it's all meat back there anyway.
Stabbed a whole bunch of people. At least that guy killed people while being stealthy.
No.
Except for the one moment where he had to shoot the dude in the butt over and over and over again.
Non-lethal.
You disappoint me for the final time, Starscream Bert.
What are you, a Metal Gear fan?
I didn't do lethal on that either.
Jeez.
Oh.
But yes.
Well, you want that big boss rank.
Continue, Justin. Continue.
Both Wolfenstein 2 and Evil Within 2 were rumored, but they weren't at the show. What happened?
They weren't. But...
just didn't show.
There was a secret teaser for Wolfenstein 2.
Yeah. And
during like the boot-up sequence of the press conference and stuff, they had a like an old computer screen thing. They had a bunch of release dates for all the games that they made, and there's something called New Colossus on there. It has no release date on it. And it's under all the other Wolfensteins.
Oh, look at that.
That's pretty smart.
But what about Half-Life 3?
Well, maybe we'll find out at the PC Game Expo thingy, PC Gamer Conference tomorrow.
Oh my god.
Someday, man, someday.
Uh-oh, that sound means we're getting close to the end of the podcast. It's other news. This only one article here. That's disappointing.
Yeah, way to not contribute.
What do you mean, Virginia? I did nothing. AMD announces the new graphics card, the Radeon RX 480, will cost $199, which is exponentially cheaper than what Scoots paid for his high-end graphics card. I added that part in there.
Oh, yes.
It is the best.
But it's much weaker.
It shares the same specs as the rumored PlayStation Neo.
Yeah, so this is basic. the PlayStation Neo is going to use a modified version of these cards. So that'll be interesting. Based on rumors, anyway.
But let me tell you one thing. Even if I got the most top-of-the-line card, this is still good.
Oh, that, the 480?
Yeah.
Yeah,
you should explain. Why is it good?
Yeah, Bert, why is it good?
Why people should shell out $199?
Why should I open my fucking wallet and release the mothballs to see why this thing is worth $199?
VR? You like VR,
Bert? I'm closing my wallet right now and slowly going back towards my pocket. You should start selling me hardcore on this. There's gotta be more than VR here.
It's as good as a Titan X. Titan X is used to cost $1,000.
I mean, my card might as well be $1,000.
Your card's more powerful. Don't worry about it.
I'm just saying, this Radeon RX 480 is 100 times better than, NVIDIA GTX 980.
It's probably on par with that.
I heard it was slightly better. Slightly.
No, that's the 1070s. Those are better than the 980s and TIs and all that. But this card is a very good entry-level card for VR.
Like, if you're into that sort of thing.
Do you remember when I told you about the Facebook Oculus Rift awesomeness? There you go.
Or if you want to try out these Fallout 4 and Doom VRs.
Or if you want to try out roller coaster VRs, there you go. You two could be in a roller coaster, then you two could fall face first into the floor.
Well, you guys haven't 100% sold me on this, so my wallet will remain in between limbo of my crotch and this wallet.
Just think
it's
of it
basically
this way.
Going to be. Oh, go on.
Just think of it this way, Mr. Tin Man. Do you like playing video games on your PC?
I might.
Do you like 1080p?
I do.
Well.
Do you plan to buy anything that's going to come out on a PC?
Perhaps.
Then you'll want a new graphics card. As these new consoles are coming out and everything, you're going to see a bigger leap in requirements.
I'm fucked then.
The best part about this, though...
The 480 will cover that stuff.
But the best part about this Radeon RX 480, Mr. Tin Man, after you get this, you won't have to upgrade for like 6 years, probably.
6 years is a good time. That's quite the...
When did you get your big Bertha, as you call it? That's quite a while ago.
It's been a while. Say 4 or 5 years, maybe. I'd have to look at the receipt.
I could hook you up with this ATI Radeon 7950.
No, I will keep whatever's inside this machine.
It will let you play those SNK games.
Never!
Yes, you want to play those SNK games.
Oh. That sound means we're running out of time, but not before we go through our Q&A session. This is my favorite part. This is the part where we get to read the questions that you, the listeners, give to us. You can do so either by leaving some in the comments below or sending some in to wolfiecoms@gmail.com. One more time, guys. Can you tell me what that is?
wolfiecoms@gmail.com.
That was really good. And
with two M's.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's wolfiecoms@gmail.com. I tried to do like a little jingle for it, but
that's not how you spell Wolfie these days.
Hey Bert, shut up. This is great.
Man,
no. Well, we have two questions this week, guys.
I'm curious. Do you get questions in the Gmail or is it from YouTube comments?
Little column A, little column B.
Are you sure?
It's mostly column A.
Yeah, I thought so.
I just want to give them the option, though.
I know. But
maybe one day they'll
know
send.
How to spell it.
Maybe spell one day I'll get it.
Weird every time.
You know
what, Bert?
Do...
Maybe we wouldn't have this problem.
What?
It's question and answer time. Damn it!
I'm not the one who made.
Don't sour this experience for me. This is the only thing I look forward to in life.
Someone else first probably has the name. That you...
First question. What? What do you? No, what do you offer?
I was just saying, someone probably has that other email. They're like, why are we getting these questions?
Who keeps asking me why? Like, what do I think of this thing? This is so weird.
Well,
first question comes in from Jin the Wolf. By the way, I want to give big shout-outs to our boy Jin the Wolf. Once again, putting in those questions. Dude, he's been consistent every single time. Sixth episode. His question is, since video games have been getting the movie treatment lately, what video games would you like to see on the big screen someday? And just to give a little precursor to this, Tetris was just announced as a movie that's going to be happening.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I mean, didn't we get Pixels? Wasn't that like the epitome of this stuff?
Do you want to know what I want?
No.
No.
No, I mean, okay. I was talking about Tetris and Pixels, but go on.
Oh, okay. Oh, if I say this, then it's going to go back to the number one thing we talked about that I got pissed off at. Ugh!
Oh, I know where you're going. Just say it.
An actual movie. Middle Gear. But then again...
I see.
Yeah.
You didn't want that Sonic 3 movie with Knuckles?
Hey,
is this one of your favorite games?
That's already been confirmed.
Are they doing one? A live action one? Live action?
Yeah, Sonic the Hedgehog movie has been in the works for years, dude. By Sony, it's going to have live action in it for some reason. Yeah,
that was going to be my favorite, but I guess I'm already getting what I want.
Bert, why you do me dirty like this?
Why you gotta be like that, Bert?
Why you do me dirty like this? You gotta
be like this.
Sonic 3. You gotta bring in Sonic 3 when I'm talking about Metal Gear.
And
don't forget Knuckles. And fuck Konami and everything.
We almost got through one podcast about this being brought up, but Bert bringing it back, running it back.
I don't know, maybe they should do a Link to the Past movie. That'd be pretty cool.
You think so, Bert? Is that your pick? You wanna be facetious here?
Since
and
I can't
say,
have that Sonic one, apparently it's already a thing.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Hold that L, Bert. L for Legend of Zelda. I will say... No, go ahead,
Just go ahead, Scoots.
Go ham on him. I ain't stopping you.
I'm not going ham. I just wanted to, there was another series I wanted to talk about that could be a movie that I would like. Bert would not say anything about this because he would be like, oh, yeah. Deus Ex.
Yeah, I could do that. Yeah. They've been doing live-action trailers for their new stuff, which have all been good.
Just say they could do Deus Ex and explore that world. If they could do an Assassin's Creed movie that just looks like crap to me, they could do a Deus Ex movie. There, you got my opinion on the Assassin's Creed movie, by the way. There you go.
If we could do a movie that wasn't, like, live-action...
Mm-hmm.
I think people would like to see an Overwatch movie.
Oh, for sure. Dude, that's basically Civil War.
Sure. Yeah, I could see that.
It is Civil War.
The thing about
Both better
Overwatch,
characters.
The thing about right. Overwatch, though, it needs more explanation of like what's going on with the game. All you know is it's just people against people. Basically Civil War. What you said, Tin Man, but like...
Yeah.
All it is plain old deathmatch.
And
dude,
how could we forget
all you
the
really
porn?
Could go by is the comics that they release and, of course, the trailer shorts.
I'm just going to say my movie I want is Overwatch porn. I want a full-length feature on that. Can I get that? That's my pick.
With D.Va and Tracer and with Widowmaker.
He just wants Reinhardt on Reinhardt.
That's true.
There's also Roadhog.
Nah, not my
bag. That guy
with
the hook.
Not my bag.
That guy with the hook you'd like.
No. There's only one. There's only room in my life for one man, and that's Reinhardt. One man.
Just like bashing the crap out of people with a hammer.
I just want to bash people in with hammers. Nothing wrong with that, right?
Until they put a character that transforms into a wolf.
Oh.
It's like guns all over him.
Oh.
That'd be so conflicting for you because you can't use guns.
It sucks. It's really a bad situation.
How about boxing glove guns?
That's good
you
for me. Like an extendo boxing glove thing.
You don't even have to aim. You just punch the crap out of them and it shoots people.
I'm okay with that. For me,
I'm endorsing that idea.
I'm super for it. I'm trying to think, what would make a good video game movie? Because there's a lot of good video game stories. It's just, I'm trying to think if you could adapt it to the big screen and if it would be interesting enough for, say, a casual audience to watch.
Last of Us would probably be one.
Yeah, that's a really good one. That's difficult. Okay. And we're assuming that the movie would be good, not like Pixels, right? We're assuming, because well, if you mean
nothing
if
could be as good as Pixels.
Nothing could ever top the quality of Pixels. Adam Sandler is a gem. I just okay, I already know what I'd say. It would never happen in a million fucking years, but because I just need this in my life, an actual Shining game movie. Not the new Tony Taka shit. The actual old school one. The lore that has been established in there. With Dark Dragon and all that.
It's okay. The closest thing you got to that is Warcraft, the movie.
No!
Oh, I heard that sounded even good.
My gut hurts now. Oh. I think that pretty much answers your question, Jin. You did say yours, Bert. Right?
Yeah, I said plenty.
He did.
I just want to make sure.
Wait, do you want a Cool Spot movie?
That would be along the lines of Bert, Pixels, Bert.
Bert, get out of here and then come back when we get to the next question.
I don't Which want is the right next, now. I don't want nothing to do Which with the second now. Question.
You it's the some, second
want,
question.
I want to hear your input on
thanks,
this.
By the way, thanks again, General, for the question. The here, second question. This one comes from Sonic the Swag Hog.
The Swag Hog. What do you guys think about the Sonic 25th anniversary?
Seeing as I'm the one that's going to have the most to talk about.
It's been 25 years of Sonic. And I think they've only had one spinball game, right?
Just one. Two.
Wasn't there supposed to be a game announcement?
Well, they have two of them?
Yeah.
What's the second one?
The second one is Sonic Spinball Party for Game Boy Advance.
What? Don't remind me about that. Oh,
yeah.
I'm going to have to look this up.
It's not actual Spinball. It's Pinball Party.
Sonic Pinball Party?
Pinball Party, not Spinball Party.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was the one with Knights.
Knights and Samba de Amigo, yeah.
Why? Ruined.
Mm-hmm. There you go. Enjoy that, Bert.
Just keep focusing on that, Bert. Yeah. It'll be fine.
Got good reviews.
Yeah.
So what do you think? Okay, so what do you think about the 25th anniversary, Mr. Tin Man?
Well, glad you asked, because here's what I think. And it's pretty much already been confirmed. It's probably going to be the Another Generations type game where they have Classic Sonic, Modern Sonic, or as they're calling it now, Adventure, I believe, and then Boom Sonic. So, there's that. I'm a little conflicted because I still like Classic Sonic. Adventure Sonic is okay, and Boom Sonic I'm iffy on. I like the show, don't like the game he's based off of, so.
Apparently, on June 22nd in Japan, there's a Sonic the Hedgehog 25th Anniversary Selection.
That's probably more than likely.
A two-disc collection of songs from mainline titles and spinoffs such as Sonic Riders packaged with the album is a bonus DVD containing 19 trailers and opening scenes. And it offers a historical timeline of sorts.
That's apparently also where they're going to be revealing the Sonic 25th Anniversary game during that event.
But can you feel the sunshine?
I can.
Does it brighten up your day?
Does I'm just I would love to have a new generations game, but I want this to be I want it to be so much better than Generations, because Generations was really good. I just want this one to go above and beyond. And for God's sakes, Sonic in there, what's that?
Are you trying to tell me you want something like a Sonic 1, which was good, and then Sonic 2, which was even better?
Yes. Actually, that's exactly what I want.
And then Sonic 3, which is 100 times better!
And Knuckles.
And then they added Knuckles, and then it's just... It's porn.
Straight up porn,
let's go.
Wait,
let's
what happened?
There. I'm ready,
wait,
I'm ready.
I'm sorry, but when did this transition happen?
I don't know.
Oh, no.
I just made something up.
Oh. The Overwatch and Sonic porn is finally crossing over. The streams have been crossed.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised that even happened, but whatever.
It's probably already have. Bert, you want to run some background checks on that and see if you can pull something up for us?
What happened?
That's right. Anyway, 25th anniversary game, it's going to be great. I have no doubt that Sonic Team won't F it up this time. Sonic Boom Fire and Ice is a different story, so...
As long as there's not a big red button, you're fine.
I don't even know if they're still, like, a company anymore. Or if they're...
Know.
Who knows at this point. I feel bad for them, kinda. Yeah, I do. They shouldn't have taken that project.
They had so many other projects they could have done.
So much potential.
So much potential, but...
So much.
They had to do that.
One final thing I want to say
on that, rushed.
Though. They got rushed. They had to put a game that was not designed for Wii U on a Wii U. And it showed. But the last thing I want to say on that is I'm not sure what the three different styles would be if they do Generations 2. Classic Sonic is self-explanatory. Adventure Sonic is...
It would be the same, but they'd have Boom Sonic as the last one.
Yeah, but what would Boom Sonic have that the other two don't?
Glitches.
Do you think the
ooh,
Boom Sonic
pad.
Section...
Yeah. Yeah, it would be annoying and it'd be broken.
Oh my god.
That'd be
dude,
Knuckles.
No, actually, I want them to do that officially in the game and reference that so it's like super meta. Like, even they know. And like the other Sonics are like, why is this guy... Why does he talk so fucking much? That would actually be... I'd be okay with that, Bert. I want that to be a thing. Super glitchy.
One
realistically, I just
all.
See it being an open world adventure type thing for him, so I don't know.
Like I said, one ring to rule them all as you take Smeagol's ring.
This robe was made for me. Bounce pad! And that's it for the Q&A session. And here it is, the end of the podcast. Wow, this is almost 3 hours. Megacast,
yeah.
Indeed.
We could always make it longer.
We yeah. could. Bert?
Do we want to do that or no?
No.
All right. We won't make it longer, then.
I mean, we're going to have to, right? Did you guys... Let's just generalize this instead, right? Do you guys have any predictions for E3 from Microsoft or Sony? I'll start with you, Scoots.
From Microsoft? Halo 3 Remastered. Why not? I actually don't really have any expectations with Microsoft at the moment, besides Crackdown 3, Halo Wars, and...
We'll have the new Gears there.
Oh, yeah, the new Gears. Yeah, I forgot about that.
Obviously, I have the Xbox One S. The big question is whether or not they'll talk about the new system. Because Sony has confirmed that they will not. But they have confirmed that it exists.
And then Sony, it would be kind of hard to explain.
Yeah, it'd be really dumb of them to come out and be like, yeah, we got a new system right now, you know? Because then Sony could be like, notes.
Well, Sony's already doing it, and they want to push VR because they have their headset coming out.
Yeah.
And they don't want to make it seem like, hey, you need this new thing for VR to work.
Can I just use the head... wow. Can I use that headset thing for just using it as a visual thing and not using
it
for VR?
I believe you can. You definitely can with, like, the Vive and stuff.
Because I could just lay on my couch looking straight up with that thing over my eyes and just play games that way and not care.
Or do I
look like a mindless drone? It's just, you know...
I don't know if laying down with that would be too comfortable, but maybe.
I'll make it comfortable, don't worry.
Walk in and just Scoots is dead on his couch because his face got impacted by the damn VR headset.
All you see is moving is my thumbs.
Or he moves his head to the side and the thing snaps his neck.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Can do that, too.
You wouldn't see us coming. What about Dragonborn? What? You think that'll show up at...
What?
Battleborn?
Dragonborn.
What is Dragonborn? I'm a Scalebound?
Scalebound, wow, what is Dragonborn?
What the hell?
No such thing. What Dragonborn is Skyrim, what they call the...
God damn it, Skyrim and Bethesda!
Scalebound. They'll probably show something, maybe.
That game looks rough. I don't know if they want to reveal it yet or if they're going back to the drawing board with it.
God damn it.
Be cool if it's there. I'd love to see what it is, but...
Me too.
No need for you to get an Xbox One anytime soon, Mr. Tin Man.
No time. As for Sony, any predictions on that one?
I don't know. Maybe we'll see Persona 5 up there. Maybe not.
You know, we'll see Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
Something
there. When's 15 due out?
September?
It can always be 7 as well. They can announce Final Fantasy 7 something.
You think they would show 7 there?
No. Who the hell knows?
I don't think so.
I'm pretty sure they got a lot more work to do.
It would be TGS or something.
Yeah, that's probably when they do it. I'm trying to think what else Sony got.
I mean, they have Star Ocean coming out, but I doubt that would be anything on a press conference.
No.
And it's already out in Japan anyway.
No, so like... I mean, we're going to see some... There's going to be a couple of things that catch us by surprise for sure, but... Oh, do you think... No, that would also be TGS, the new Nier.
Nier's there. It's on the Square Enix like broadcast stuff.
Oh, I stand corrected then.
They're having like an hour of signings and stuff. Talking with the developers or something. I don't know. It'll be like on Thursday or something like that.
Oh. So that's a little while off. Just a couple of days off.
Sony will definitely have the new Call of Duty. They had it last year.
That'll go over well, I'm sure.
Yep.
And I guess other than that, that's pretty much it. That's it for the podcast.
Just want to get out of here.
The length on... there's nothing else to talk about.
Nintendo.
Okay. We actually talked about that earlier.
I know.
Yeah, they don't even have a conference, so it's fine.
Like, that's it. Anything,
Ubisoft and the PC Gaming Expo thing.
Hey, okay, let's just go ahead and...
No, we're good.
Let's go ahead and just pat his head here. And it's okay. It's okay, Vert. I know you want to talk. What do you want to talk about Ubisoft?
For Honor.
What?
You remember?
For Honor.
For Honor.
The game you said looks good.
Oh, that one.
Yeah, For Honor.
Yeah. What was that on again? It's been so long since we saw that.
Everything.
You think they got to show that?
Probably. It missed last year.
I would actually be okay with seeing that because that game looked pretty good when we last saw it. Hey, wait, oh my god, did you say Ubisoft is making that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, time for the Ubisoft downgrade when we eventually see it again.
Every game goes through that, but yes.
But the Ubisoft games get it the worst.
Not always. They're just the new punching bag.
Sure they are, Vert. You're such a devil's advocate, apologist, man. Just let me go ham on them and let them take it. They're big companies, they can take it.
As long as you ease up on EA.
Fuck EA!